Great record, 118 wins, 97 losses, and six ties. Very affable coach, Grant Taft. Back to receive the kickoff. Baylor will kick off, although they did win the toss. They will defer. Kicking it off will be Jeff Ireland. We talked about him in the opening. He has been named as the starting kicker just before kickoff, just prior to the game, and back deep as we look at R.C. Slocum in his third year at Texas A&M. 20 wins, three losses, and a tie. Wilbert, Beggins, and Simmons will be back deep. With a strong kick that will land 7 yards deep and a touchback. The Aggies will start on their own 20-yard line. Back Bucky Richardson, 6'2" tall, 221 pounds, a senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. A very tough individual, unquestionably the leader of this offense. Greg Hill, the super freshman from Dallas's Carter High School, with 543 yards rushing already this season. On the offensive line, John Elliser is the lone returning starter. First down and 10. Carter and Hill are the backs. Richardson, play action, passing on the first play of the game, complete, out to the 42.
It's complete to Tony Harrison, Tony. And this is what we were talking about, Mark, right there in the on camera. They've got to throw on first down to be effective, and if they can do that and be successful, it'll open up things for Greg Hill, the freshman sensation at tailback.
Tony Harrison, the go-to receiver for the Aggies. Look at the Baylor defense. Santana Dotson, a Lombardi nominee, and a surefire first-round pick in June. Lots of talent up front. The linebackers, Brian Hand, the man to watch, and Clifford Ellison with an interception on the first play of the game last week. First down.
Gain of 22 on that first play.
The handoff now to Hill. And Hill is up over the 45 to the 46-yard line, where Michael McFarland made the tackle. McFarland, 5'10" tall, 169 pounds, and he's a junior. Look at the freshman, though. Greg Hill.
There's Hill. He's the fastest A&M back since Curtis Dickey way back in the 70s. He had a 212 yards in his first game against LSU. He's special.
Second down and 6 now for Texas A&M. Richardson to toss. To Hill again. And he's up into Baylor territory at the 48-yard line. DeShane Maxson on the tackle.
Well, he's the leading tackler, too. Watch number 7. 7 comes in, skates down the line of scrimmage all the time, keeping the ball carrier in his eyes, almost overran it. But it's that kind of outside-in support that they're going to have to get on Hill because he never offers his body to the tackler, his full body.
Close to a first down. They bring the chains in from the sidelines, and it is a Texas A&M first down.
All right, you know what this does now. Right away, you're building confidence of this very, very young team. If you look just at that offensive line that you talked about, you've got 3 sophomores, a junior and a senior, so it's extremely young, and your running back's a freshman. Confidence is building quickly here.
The ball is at the 48. The opening drive for the Aggies. Mitchell goes in motion. The handoff to Hill, and he breaks a tackle close to the 40-yard line. Down to the 41. Curtis Hafford made the tackle.
See, even the dogs are barking. Everything's exciting. Hey, I don't think we should be surprised about this. The Aggies have scored on their opening drive in all 4 games this year, and they've outscored their opponents 114-10 in the first half. It's a quick-starting football team. And as we were told just by Bob Toledo before the game, the offensive coordinator, they're too young and too stupid to know they aren't supposed to play well here.
Sharp and Matthews, 2 tight ends in the ball game. Sharp goes in motion. The toss to Hill. Little room over the right side, down to the 36-yard line, where LeShane Maxson again made the stop. Maxson is only 193 pounds, and he claims that he is over 200 now, fairly light for a linebacker.
Well, that's another first down now for Texas A&M, so they continue to move the football and move it effectively. This is what I was talking about with Greg Hill. If you look at that, those are the top freshman rushers the Aggies have had. Hill, of course, out to a quick start, 533 yards, and he got 212 of those the very first week.
Says that Darren Lewis is his idol. They went to the same high school in Dallas.
Grew up just a block away from each other.
First down and 10. Richardson on the toss, on the option. Hill lost his footing and got back to the 37-yard line where Hafford made the stop.
Well, see, now they went to the option for the first time this afternoon, and it's basically an option team. But what happened here now, you had Baylor off balance. You were passing, you were coming up with quick openers, you even had a trap in there. So what happens is now you come back to what you do, and that's what they've prepared for when they stop it.
No gain on the play. It'll be second and 10.
You know, Bucky's first collegiate start was against Baylor, 1987, right here in this stadium, and A&M won it 34-10.
The wide receivers are split. Richardson to pass. And he'll take off on his own. Bucky Richardson eludes one tackler and is run out of bounds to the 16-yard line by Brian Hand. A 22-yard gain by Richardson as he displays his running ability.
This will dispel any problems that he may have with his foot. They said he wasn't 100%. Watch the cut with his right leg right here. See him push off and around the linebacker, and then he just takes it out outside. One of the keys to this thing is they took Santana Dotson out of the play, the right tackle. Watch him. Look, right there. They tackle him and then push him down from behind, and that's why the play worked.
First and 10, Hill. Got over the 15, down to the 14. Hand with the tackle.
Pretty impressive when you can say you've scored on your first drive in every ball game in the year. Boy, they say Hill's got more speed than Darren Lewis. He was recruited and seriously considered coming to Baylor right here in Waco.
He has rushed for over 100 yards three times already this season. Second down and 9, two tight ends in the ball game. Sharp in motion. Richardson on the option, keeps it himself, and gets down to the 12.
Dangerous situation right now for that man, R.C. Slocum. He got into a situation he didn't want to get into, and that's third and long. They're going to need 5, maybe 6 yards here, and that's the situation where this Baylor defense, which is extremely active, can just load its ears up, pull them back, and ready to rush. They're going to come after you here.
It's third down and 6.
This is a Baylor defense that doesn't blitz a lot. They get the push straight ahead with their front four, actually a front eight.
Hill and Carter in the backfield. The draw to Hill. Nothing doing.
Now, see, it was a third down play. It was the first third down situation that A&M had on this drive, and that's not what you want to do against this Baylor attack. They call that front eight. The eight ball posse, and this is why they pinch from the outside to get pursuit from the inside. There's nowhere to run, and Hill tries to cut and slips down. They had him covered from every conceivable angle.
Terry Vinatulius now will come in to attempt the field goal. The holder is Brian Payne. This one coming from 39 yards out. Pardon me, 29, and it's good. So Texas A&M takes the ball, marches down, and scores 3. We'll be right back.
Last year, the average price of a car with standard anti-lock brakes was over $40,000. But today, all that's changed. Because we understand the real value of safety, we put anti-lock brakes standard on more models than anyone. Even on our least expensive Cavalier. Chevrolet.
The heartbeat of America.
The cars more people depend on.
That's today's Chevrolet.
The American Society for Testing and Materials set a new technical standard for antifreeze used to protect heavy-duty truck engines against boiling, freeze-ups, and corrosion. Only one of the three best-selling antifreeze brands made for cars meets that standard. It's the patented car antifreeze that can also keep heavy-duty engines running
at their peak.
Protect your engine from freeze-ups and boilovers. Remember the heavy duty. Don't stop short of the peak.
It's going to be a good week to keep in touch.
Remember the day at the ballpark when I hit the ball and ran and slid in my head and I was 6 months.
You had a crush on my brother?
Well, she reminds me so much of you.
AT&T Reunion Week starts this Monday, and it's just 11 cents a minute for an out-of-state call. Anywhere in the U.S. from 5 to 11 p.m. So what are you waiting for?
Hey, all right.
Just 11 cents a minute to reach anyone, anywhere, all week.
Well, you're looking at the scoring drive. Texas A&M taking 5 minutes, 22 seconds to put 3 points on the board. And now they will kick it off. One of the great traditions at Texas A&M is what they call the 12th man. They just take a student out of the student body. He's not on a scholarship. He's just an everyday student. Robert Watson is the man who you're looking at right there. He's 5'11", 175-pound sophomore. We'll watch him.
Back deep, it's Bell and Lee Miles. A short kick, it'll land at about the 15. Miller takes it out to the 33-yard line.
They're going to bring this one back, Mark. There's a flag down. I believe it's going to be a clip on Baylor.
It's a 20-yard return.
And it might be on the 12th man. I think Robert Watson got pushed in the back after he got a pretty good lick in the front.
And they'll bring this one back. .932 remaining in the first quarter.
Yeah, there was an illegal block, no question.
We have clipping on the receiving team on a return. First down.
Well, the Baylor offense is directed by J.J. Joe. 5'11", 178 pounds, a sophomore from Arlington, Texas. They call him Magic, and throughout the course of the game, you'll find out why. He'll make some magical plays. In the backfield, David Mims and Melvin Bonner, averaging almost 29 yards per reception. He's their home run hitter. On the offensive line, John Turnpaugh, who decided to stay for his senior season, turning down the National Football League. Baylor starts on their own 9-yard line. Running the veer offense. Joe to pass on the first play to Mims. There's a flag down on the play as Mims is tackled by Crooms at the 13-yard line. Might have been some illegal motion.
It's going to be against Texas A&M. They jumped across. I think the motion may have thrown them off. You're going to see some new wrinkles today from Baylor. Perhaps more motion, several different formations. The key is going to be Bonner. They'll move Bonner into about 3 or 4 different positions.
And now a look at the Texas A&M defense. Sam Adams, one of the top high school players in the nation last year. The linebackers led by Quentin Coria. In the words of his coach, R.C. Slocum, a man, a stud. And Kevin Smith is the Thorpe Award nominee. He is on the corner. He has 19 career interceptions.
He's the leader, too. 6 foot, 180 pounds. He'll support on the run. Certainly one of the more historical defensive lines we've seen with Sam Adams and Patrick Henry.
First and five now. The handoff goes to Straight. He takes it straight up the middle to the 18-yard line. Robert Straight, 6'1", 230 pounds. He's tackled by Sam Adams. Straight averaging 6.3 yards per carry. What a story he is. Underwent arthroscopic surgery a couple weeks ago and was back riding a bicycle after just 3 days. Second down and two. Straight and wide of the backs now. Two wide receivers outright. Bonner goes in motion. The handoff goes to the fullback, Straight. And Straight moves out to the 35-yard line where he's tackled by Patrick Bates, the free safety. an 18-yard gain by Robert Strait.
You know what's unique about Strait? He's 230 pounds. He can make a cut and splatter people as well. He's got power. He's got speed. Once he gets into the secondary, he's like a bull. You got to double team him and take him down. He's a great talent, as you mentioned, coming back from arthroscopic surgery.
First down and 10 for the Bears. McKenzie and Pierce, two tight ends in the ballgame for Baylor. Joe fakes the handoff and is sacked back at the 25.
Otis nearly came clean and made the sack. That's his second sack of the year. Boy, I'm telling you, A&M ranks right up there with Penn State when it comes to linebackers. And here's one of them right here. This is an overachiever. Nearly 6'1", 217-pounder. Nobody picks him up. The backside block got there too late, and he made the sack. Boy, they've had All-Americans like Johnny Holland, John Roper, Aaron Wallace, William Thomas. Every starting A&M linebacker over the last 10 years has gotten a shot at the NFL.
Linebacker U South. It's second and 20. Strait and White are in the backfield. Joe passes incomplete. The intended receiver was Melvin Bonner. As I mentioned earlier, Bonner coming into the ballgame averaging 28.4 yards per reception. He is their home run hitter.
Baylor had gotten away from the beer in the 80s because of the personnel. And in 1989, they went back to the option football and the option pass. And that guy right there, number 13, J.J. Joe, is one of the reasons. He jumped in, and he's been an outstanding quarterback in the beer.
And they face a third and 19. Joe back to pass. And he tucks it under and takes it himself. Joe is run out of bounds at the 38-yard line. Far short of a first down. Marcus Buckley, the 6'4", 225-pound junior, pushed him out. And the A&M defense holds on Baylor's first possession. Kent Brentham now will come into punt for the Bears. Back deep, Kevin Smith. A high kick that lands at the 21-yard line. Smith tiptoes his
ball loose
to the 27 and a fumble.
There's also a flag. The ball was knocked loose. We're waiting for the signal there. I think he was already down. His knee was down, but there is a flag, definitely.
It was a 40-yard punt, a 5-yard return by Smith.
We have a dead ball, personal foul against the kicking team.
Personal foul against Baylor.
Down. 6:47 to play in the first quarter. It's 3-0 for Texas A&M.
Sharp brings you the world of big events. The big bowl games, concerts, the championship games, the playoffs, title fights, hit movies, big events the way they were meant to be seen. Big on Sharp Vision, the liquid crystal projection system with the 8-foot picture that makes you feel like you're there. Now, see the Holyfield-Tyson fight on Sharp Vision. Come in for a demonstration, and you could win a trip to the fight. Buy Sharp Vision and get a $500 rebate.
American performer in track and basketball, played in the NFL with the Cardinals and the 49ers. John David Crow, now the athletic director at Texas A&M University. And he says that that 1956 game between Baylor and Texas A&M was the hardest hitting football game he ever played in. First down and 10 for the Aggies. Hill out to the 43-yard line. He's tackled by Hafford. Gain of 2 yards on the play. It'll be second and 8 now.
Interesting start for Texas A&M. You know, this team lost 4 of its top 5 offensive linemen last year, including All-American center Mike Arthur. They're pulling that all together right now, and the offense has really come, I think, to the point where it's almost as lethal as it was last year.
Two wide receivers out to the left. The backs are split.
Flea flicker.
Richardson.
He's got him.
Incomplete, intended for Brian Mitchell.
Great recovery by Keith Caldwell, number three, the free safety. Because I'm telling you right now, Mitchell was behind the secondary. Just the flea flicker. Get it back to Richardson. Good protection up there. He's got all times, all day to throw. And here comes Mitchell behind the secondary. The ball was underthrown. Caldwell caught up to him and knocked it away.
That'll set up third down and eight now. Look at Caldwell, 5'11", 173 pounds, a senior. He had three interceptions coming into the ball game today.
Yeah, he knows he made a great play, but he also knows he was lucky to get there. He was beaten.
Mitchell and Harrison, the receivers. Richardson to pass to the tight end, Schrock. He's chased out of bounds at midfield by Lachey Maxson.
All that for naught. They're going to bring it back. I think Texas A&M was holding. Yep, there they go. They'll bring it back. This where you have two evenly matched teams playing for the conference lead, the team that makes the fewest mistakes will win, because neither one of these teams has that much more talent than the other to overcompensate. So if you make a lot of mistakes, that's going to be the difference.
This young Aggie team looking very poised in the early going so far.
Well, they got away with a hold or two early on. We saw that. They were holding Santana Dotson. This time they get caught.
Third down, 21 yards to go. Beggins and Harrison are out wide. Richardson out of the shotgun. Steps up. He's dragged down at the 35-yard line by number 99, Curtis Happer.
That play was made by Santana Dotson. He could be the best defensive lineman in the entire country. He played hurt for 3 weeks. He's just now getting healthy again. He's a finalist for the Football News Defensive Player of the Year. He's the one that chased Richardson out of the pocket.
David Davis now back deep to punt for Texas A&M. Frankie Smith is standing on his own 25-yard line.
Play clock has already expired. There better be a flag. I don't see one yet.
And now the whistle goes.
See that? It's been expired for a good 5 seconds. Still no flag down. Now the officials, I think they went to sleep. It was the Baylor defenders that started saying, hey, the clock is expired. There's still no flag on the field.
Delay of the game.
That's incredible. That is incredible. The Baylor defense, they called the penalty, and they were right. But the officials never saw the clock expire. They completely forgot about the play clock.
So they move it back 5 yards. Baylor with some good pressure. Smith takes it on the run at the 38. And he's stopped at the 43
by Kevin Smith.
3-0 A&M.
Every business morning, while the rest of the world is getting up, UPS is guaranteeing overnight delivery before 10:30 for far less than other companies charge. And every business morning, more people are waking up to that fact.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Since we became employee-owned, I think there's a far greater commitment to providing good quality service.
Roving Rapid Return is really fast. I meet you at your car, push a couple of buttons, hand you a receipt, and you're out of there.
So why rent from anyone but an owner?
It took all day, but they finally came up with one very big idea. What do you bet they printed on a laser jet from Hewlett-Packard?
It's not easy being a truck.
Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me.
But through it all,
he
Chevy full size has the best resale value in the business. Chevy trucks.
Like a rock.
The trucks you can depend on. The trucks that last.
You're going to look at a friendly guy. His name, Judge Sam, the Baylor mascot. Not your everyday house pet. He's trained by Johnny Williams of the Baylor Chamber of Commerce. Now, the Bears are rotated every 2 years because of the difficulty handling bears over 2.5 years old.
Here come the judge.
Bringing order to the football field this afternoon. It's 3-0 Texas A&M, 4:44 to play in the first quarter. J.J. Joe and the Baylor Bears take over at their own 45-yard line. Two receivers out left. Joe looks over the middle, incomplete for Bonner. Well, next Saturday on ABC, beginning at 3:30 Eastern time, regional action. Most of you will see Mississippi State against Auburn in this area of the country. Check your local listings for the game in your area next Saturday on ABC. It's 2nd and 10 now. Straight and Mims are in the backfield. They line up in the eye. Joe to pass. The out pattern incomplete, intended for Lee Miles. Joe underthrew his receiver.
We've seen three different kinds of passes now from J.J. Joe. Three-step, which this one is, and just tries to get it out there because of the pressure he's been getting from the A&M guys. He didn't set, didn't throw off his back foot. Consequently, he was underthrown. We've also seen him go to the veer action, which is faking to the fullback, then stepping and popping quick, which was the pass before that. And then we'll see the drop back, too. So he'll use all three.
Third down and 10. Two receivers out to the left. And now Mims leads up into the slot. Joe, incomplete for Bonner. That one was definitely a catchable ball.
Oh, and he knows it. You see him, he pointed to himself, pointed right there to the 8 and the 3. He said, that's my fault. I dropped it. He's the inside receiver who'll get to the outside quickly. The inside receiver is always the most dangerous, has the most field to work with, got a late break on the ball and just tried to lunge and should have had it. He knows it.
Kent Brentham back to punt. Kevin Smith is deep for the Aggies. A high kick. Smith calls for the fair catch at his own 18. A 37-yard punt by Brentham.
Boy, this is a school which is just loaded, and I mean loaded with great traditions. I mean, you talk about the 12th man, you talk about the music of Aggie Land right there with the band, songs of Texas A&M. This is the military uniforms they have, you know, and they've gone through when it wasn't vogue to be military. During the Vietnam situation, it's all stuck. Now, after Desert Storm, it is in vogue again.
First and 10, a handoff to Hill. He lowers his head and gets out to the 22. Brought down by Marcus Lowe. Well, you know, Brett Taft is really a master of motivation. He has done just about everything when it comes to motivating his players. He told us about his philosophy.
Very simple. I believe in self-motivation. And I don't think that anyone can last very long somebody else motivating. And it comes down to a point where, as an individual, you have to find your own hot button and become motivated. And what I try to do is just teach youngsters how to become self-motivated. I'm not some big motivator that gives poignant speeches. I try to teach.
He is indeed a teacher. Brian Mitchell with the complete pass. Again, out to the 39-yard line. Texas A&M.
It's enough for the first down. Richardson put it right on a rope. He's throwing extremely well. We said he had to throw more today, and he's been doing that. That'll take some of the heat off the Baylor heat seekers.
Two tight ends in the ballgame now. The toss to Hill. They turn it inside, and he's dragged down over the 42 by Haffer.
You know, Hill is having trouble with his footing. We've seen him two or three times now try to make a cut, and he slides down. I don't know if it's the shoes he's wearing or what the problem is, but the AstroTurf, this artificial surface here, is causing some problems for him. Look at that. See, he's got the waffle shoes on. It's almost like regular tennis shoes, and he's not getting enough traction on those. He may have to change those shoes.
Well, Hill has predicted a big game this afternoon against Baylor. Two tight ends still in the ball game. Second and six. Richardson on the option, keeps it himself, steps up the middle. Into Baylor territory at the 46-yard line. Bucky Richardson, very adept at running the ball.
Well, I tell you what he's adept at. He's adept at reading the defense. This Baylor defense is so fast, they were actually shifting and trying to slant toward the ball, and he cut back with the draw play, the quarterback draw.
There was a penalty against Baylor. Here's the call.
We have offside.
Well,
on the
Richardson
defense.
Averages 7 yards
a
carry.
First down.
Bucky Richardson, we talked about his running ability. Very strong runner. Not really built like your typical quarterback. 221 pounds, and he's closing in on Marty at Aiken's record. The rushing quarterbacks in this conference. First and 10. Sharp in motion. The toss to Hill. And he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
Ball carrier number 27, Greg Hill.
Hill, very valuable to his team. And speaking of valuable players, at the conclusion of today's game, we'll be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. And for the 21st year, through the Chevrolet Scholarship Program, $1,000 will be donated to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. Second and seven, the ball at the 44. The receivers are split. Richardson hands it off again to Hill. He breaks a tackle and gets down to the 34-yard line. Strong running by Greg Hill, the freshman. Ellison made the tackle.
Two-time high school All-American sprinter. Watch what he comes through here. It's more of a leap and balance. See this? Then he explodes through there, kind of jumped over the legs of his lineman rather than trip over him. He wears a gold chain necklace with the number 27 dangling next to a hat with the letters GHT, which stands for Greg Hill Time.
What time is it?
Greg Hill Time, and it has been in this first quarter.
First down and 10. 1:20 to play in the first quarter. Two receivers out to the left of Richardson. The handoff up the middle to Hill. Stopped at the 33 by Maston.
Tackled on the play by Baylor's number 99, Curtis Heffert.
Haven't seen much of Santana Dotson. Watch him, 77. Who is that up there? Well, that's John Ellister, the senior, or the junior, rather, the only returning starter from last year. Soft-spoken guy, very polite off the field, but on the field, look at him. He's playing well against the guy that everybody says could be the best defensive lineman in the nation, and that's Santana Dotson.
A lot of credentials. Second down and 9. Two tight ends in for Texas A&M. Sharp in motion. Richardson on the option, tosses it to Hill, and he's got it out. Hill is tackled at the 15-yard line by Frankie Smith, but not before a gain of 19 yards.
He's approaching the 100-yard mark right here in the first half. They pull Ellisor. Watch this. He comes over, gets in front of him. They throw the block, the kickout block, and then he's looking for a block from Tony Harrison, the split end. Harrison got stuck on the strong safety, and that's the only reason they caught Hill in the secondary.
66 yards. And we haven't even seen the end of the first quarter yet.
But you know why? It's been effective. He's been effective because Richardson's been able to throw on early downs.
And Richardson calls a timeout. Talk it over with head coach R.C. Slocum. Boy, you talk about a coach paying his dues, Tim. R.C. Slocum was an assistant coach at Texas A&M for 16 years.
Well, that's right. His overall time spent with Texas A&M has been 19 years. He's a gentleman. He's also an outstanding coach. He's in his third year now as head coach, and he's got a record of 28-1. That's a pretty talent. I've got a question. This timeout, though, with 9 seconds remaining in the quarter, they were about to get a timeout anyway, and when you're the visiting team, you want to melt that clock. You want to get it down to a one-quarter football game.
Now, We talked earlier about Grant Tapp and his motivational techniques. We heard from the head coach of Baylor. One of his techniques is something called the Secret Society of the Gold Dot. And there you see the gold dot. What he does is give each of his players a gold dot to put on their watches to remind them of their goals. And here's what gold stands for. The G for goals, the O for oneness, loyalty, and determination. There's a look at the head coach.
Southwest Coach of the Year 6 times. National Coach of the Year 1974. He's coached 15 first-time, first-team All-Americans. And he's a gentleman.
9 seconds to play in the first quarter. First and 10 for Texas A&M. Richardson hands it off the hill. He's stopped behind the line of scrimmage at the 17. That's the end of the first quarter. Texas A&M knocking on the door. They lead 3-0.
Stood there boldly, sweating in the sun. Felt like a million. Felt like number one. Like a rock. I was strong as I could be, like a rock. Nothing ever got to me, like a rock. I was something to see, like a rock.
The trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last.
Like a rock.
Chevy trucks.
Stand an arrow straight, like a rock. Charging from the gate.
A little brains, a little luck, and a lot of late nights. A good family, a good spot, and some good advice. That's the way it's supposed to be. USF&G is standing behind me. That's the way it's supposed to be. USF&G is standing behind me.
Morning belongs to Skin Bracer Aftershave. Its cool, brisk tingle really gets you going. And what a great scent. Skin Bracer.
No better way to face the day you find it.
Imagine a rent-a-car company that offers special delivery right to your door. That's Enterprise.
Here, let me help you.
Enterprise, a special rent-a-car company that gives you special delivery.
At Texas A&M, I've been given the opportunity to work on real projects that aren't just for a grade. I'm gaining great experience.
Experience is important in and out of the classroom. Our physics students are hunting new particles at the Super Collider and building satellite technology at Texas A&M.
Texas A&M University has been demonstrating its commitment to education for over 115 years. Soon, we'll be the proud host of the nation's newest presidential library.
Texas A&M University, a leader in education in and out of the classroom.
Welcome back to Floyd Casey Stadium. Mark Jones along with Tim Brandt. You're looking at R.C. Slocum, the head coach of Texas A&M. His team leading 3-0. Quarterback Bucky Richardson bringing the Aggies up to the line of scrimmage at the 17 at 2nd and 12. The back's in the eye. Richardson rolling out. Throws complete to Harrison. And Harrison fighting his way to the 7. Ellison in on the tackle.
Dangerous pass. What they did is they moved the pocket. They had him sprint out to alleviate some of the pressure. But watch this. Number 33, McFarland, the strong safety, goes for the interception. Tried to knock it away. When he dives, he's out of the way. And then they take it down. And now they've got third down and about one.
Harrison came into the ballgame with 12 receptions for 205 yards.
This would be a great chance right here to throw. Third down and one.
Two tight ends in the ballgame. Carter in the backfield. Sharp in motion to give us the Carter. Up and over the top for a first down.
Number 2, Carter, the
Doug Carter, 210 pounds, a junior. He's been slowed by ankle injuries this year, but he has bounced back.
Sat out 2 years after knee surgery. You know, Robert Wilson was the fullback, but he left A&M early to go to the NFL. And that gave Doug Carter a shot. He's capitalized. He's got good hands, good speed. So A&M would like to get him the football more often.
Hill and Carter in the backfield. Three tight ends now for A&M. On first and goal, they go to Hill, who bangs his way down to the two in the middle of the field.
We've been seeing a lot of two tight ends, and they're following those tight ends as well. Look, they load them up on the left side. They call that their elephant or jumbo formation. All the big guys are in there, and they try to take the little guy, Hill, who's only 5'11", 190, put him right up the butt of those big tight ends.
Hill and Carter remain in the game, in the backfield. Second down and goal. Still three tight ends. Richardson on the keeper. Didn't gain many yards on that play, maybe a half yard. Tracy Miller dragged him down. That's going to set up third and goal.
You know, inside the 20, we talked about this earlier, Texas A&M is almost perfect. They've scored 24 out of 25 times down here. If I'm on defense, I'm keying Greg Hill right now. Wherever he goes, I'm going that direction.
To stay with Hill and Carter. Richardson on the option and the toss. Touchdown Hill.
Says he didn't get in. What they're saying is that Hill's knee hit before the ball crossed the plane.
Have another look at this.
Now they came with the option. Right now I said Key Hill. So they set the safety after him. And number three, Caldwell, followed him all the way. Now see if his knee touches. Right there, bang, he's down. The ball, you can see, is still not across the plane. It'll bring up fourth down and less than one. Great play by the free safety, Keith Caldwell.
Richardson, this time, no mistake, touchdown. Richardson says, I'll do it myself. Tullius in for the extra point. A&M leads 10 to nothing with 12-12 remaining in the first half.
You know, if you pay as much attention to your jump shot as you do trying to impress women.
Well, it's just this new shampoo.
My hair comes out looking really good. Shampoo.
Yeah, it's got a conditioner in it, right in the bottle.
Talked about this before.
What?
Look, all the conditioner in the world doesn't mean a thing. The minute your dandruff shows up.
Ah, fear not, paranoid one.
For the first time ever, the world's leading dandruff shampoo comes complete with full-body conditioners. Introducing Head & Shoulders 2-in-1, making all your first impressions all the more impressive.
Imagine. Suspension Bridge, that's quite a story. They had cattle and everybody else and carriages and horses coming across that for the last 100 years.
Vinatulius will kick it off now for Texas A&M. Bell and Miller are standing on the 5-yard line for Baylor. And this one goes out of bounds. The Aggies will have to kick it over again. And look at our 12th man having a rough time today. Coming up this Monday, the Cincinnati Bengals taking on the Buffalo Bills. This game in Buffalo beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern time here on ABC. And boy, Sam Wyche and his team struggling, to say the least, this year. 0-6.
Baylor had an option. They could have made Texas A&M kick it again. Instead, they took it on the 35-yard line. So the Bears start with good field position. Two things we talked about, the young kids for A&M now have tremendous confidence, where the confidence for Baylor, I think, has been rocked a little bit.
And the crowd here, Floyd Casey, is silent. The give is to the fullback, Robert Strait, up the middle. A look at the scoring drive. Richardson tucked it under himself, punched it over for the touchdown. They used 7:10 on the clock
and 15 plays. That's phenomenal. I'll tell you something right now, as we look at the offense and defense, this defense is first in the conference and sixth in the nation. It allows only 270 yards a game, but Baylor averages over 500, so therein lies the conflict.
Backs in the eye, Bonner in motion, Joe on the tops, to Mims. Gets outside and cuts it up in, down to the 48. David Mims, the leading rusher coming into the ballgame for the Bears. He had 461 yards on 78 carries. He suffered a bruised shoulder last week in the game against Rice. He really took a hit in that game, but has had a good week of practice. Is back for this one. First and 10 now. Strait and Greg White now in the backfield. They have the tight end lined up right behind Joe, and he'll go in motion. Joe hands it off to the fullback, Robert Strait. That's a formation that they used last week against Rice, and the first time that they've gone to it this week against A&M. Quentin Corriott made the tackle. That's what RC had to say about him.
He is that. He's a candidate for the Butkus Award, the nation's top linebacker. He's matched up with the fullback Strait all day. He'll be a top-rated player in the draft.
Pierce goes in motion. Here's Joe. Keeps it. And Joe gets down to the 37-yard line. Patrick Bates, the free safety, came up to make the tackle.
All right, we've set the stage now. A&M is an aggressive defense, so J.J. Joe is running more motion today. They'll run reverses, and the Bears even put a trap play in this week. But J.J. Joe saw that they were trying to shut down Strait. They were forcing and pinching inside in the middle, so he took it around the corner.
Joe is not the type of quarterback that will get himself beat. Doesn't turn the ball over that much.
It's enough for the first down.
10:44 remaining in the first half. Texas A&M leads Baylor 10-0.
J.J. Joe came all the way off to the sidelines. Did you see him there to talk to Grant Taft? The play clock now is already down to 18, so he's got to get in the huddle and get out of the huddle quickly. He does.
Mims and Strait are in the backfield. Melvin Bonner comes out wide to the left.
Oh, how about that?
Smacked.
I want to tell you something.
Eric England that time.
England is just a sophomore. Came in for Teichelman. And I mean, he bounced right up there in straight space. He's another one of the sophomores, 6'3", 243 pounds. This team has 26 freshmen and sophomores listed on the first and second teams. I mean, they play a young, young football team.
Reggie Miller brings the play into the ballgame. It's second and 10. Bonner in the slot this time. He goes in motion to the right. Joe gives it to the fullback, Strait, who moves down to the 32-yard line.
Neely just got there late. Neely, number 56, he's the outside linebacker, didn't close down quickly enough.
Robert Strait has three 100-yard games already this season, averaging 6.3 yards per rush.
Well, he's the key to this Baylor attack, too. He's the hammer guy inside. Now, he ran for over 8,000 yards in high school, if you can believe that. They believe the shortest distance between two points is a straight line, and they spell it S-T-R-A-I-T.
The Bears call timeout. 9:14 remaining in the second quarter. It's 10-0 for Texas A&M.
When you've got something precious to carry, here's another Chevy Lumina Euro sedan. Engineered with four-wheel independent suspension and standard anti-lock brakes. It's one way to help make sure your precious cargo is delivered safely. The cars more people depend on.
Chevy Lumina. Family Circle's domestic family car of the year for the second straight year.
Searching for the perfect shave? Let Norelco show you what it's like from the inside. Here, there's a system for a close, comfortable shave that exists in no other razor. Our patented lift and cut system lifts the hair so when it's cut, it can actually drop below skin level without the blades even touching your face. So to look better on the surface, remember, Norelco shaves below the surface. Norelco, we make close, comfortable.
When the Rutledge family needs auto, home, life, or health insurance, they see me. I'm their State Farm agent, Billy King. They keep seeing me as I help them keep their coverages up to date with our State Farm family insurance checkups. When they have a claim, they see me. And thanks to our checkups, the protection has been there. If you want to see a family insurance agent working for you, see a State Farm agent.
And like a good neighbor, Century is there.
Well, his teammates call him Magic. His name is J.J. Joe, one of the best nicknames in all of college football. We asked him how he got it.
Well, it started out as J.J. My mom always called me J.J., and that stood for John Joe. And once I got involved in sports in high school, people used to say, well, what's your last name? And I said, Joe. And they said, well, J.J. Joe. And before I could say, well, no, they started printing in the paper, so that's how I got started.
One of the all-time great names
in college football. You can call me J.J.
Call him a winner. Third and six. Backs are in the eye. Straight and Mims in the backfield.
Joe doesn't have a completion yet. He's 0 for 4, and they jump anyway.
And movement on the right side of that Baylor offensive line.
Boy, Baylor's really struggling right now.
They have a dead ball, false start on the offense. Still third down.
You have to wonder how much last week's game out of Rice really took out of them. Watch the left side of your screen. That's the right side of the offensive line, and they just jumped out of there. You see, Joe was trying to tell him which way the play was going to go, but check with me, and he was yelling to his backs, and the right side of his line, which really couldn't hear him that closely because he was looking left, they heard the cadence and just jumped.
Lee Miles bringing the ball, the play into the game.
They can bring the ball, too. They can play with two balls. Right now, I tell you, they're out of sync. They need help.
Miles and Bonner, the receivers. Third and 11. Joe to pass. Over the middle, complete to Bonner. Now we'll have to look at the spot. It appeared that he got down to the 22.
Oh, he's got plenty for the first down. He made the first down by about 5 or 6 yards. You know what shows me something about Joe is the way he stepped up and drilled it. Now here comes Bonner working into a zone defense, finds the open area and just kind of skates to it. And when he turned, the ball was waiting for him there. Just kind of found himself right in front of Bates, the safety.
Bonner with 4-2 speed, first and 10. Joe gives it to the fullback, who gets down to the 13-yard line.
You know, straight slapping the ground, and he's slapping himself and shaking his head. You know why? He knows he had a touchdown if he could have just kept his feet. That man knows it too, R.C. Slocum. He was in the secondary, nobody there, and he slipped on the carpet.
Second down and one. Little or no gain on that play. Straight was stopped up at the line of scrimmage. Mark Wheeler made the tackle. Well, tonight on ABC, after all new episodes of Who's the Boss and Growing Pains, it's Madonna in the network television premiere of Who's That Girl, an ABC movie special presentation tonight, The Material Girl. Third down and two. Joe steps up to the line of scrimmage with three tight ends in the game.
See if it goes to the left side here. It does.
The toss to Mims. He gets outside and he's tripped up at the six. Patrick Bates came up from his free safety spot to get him out of bounds.
There's another flag though, Mark. The slant's going to the left side. J.J. Joe sees that, sends the motion to the left. and they go in that direction. But once again, they're going to move Baylor back for illegal procedure, and the Bears are killing themselves.
We have illegal motion on the offense. We'll replay third down.
They've got four seniors on that offensive line for Baylor, an experienced group, the type of group that you wouldn't expect many mistakes from. It's third down and seven. Three wide receivers in. Miles, Miller, and Bonner.
A&M coming with the blitz. Here they come.
Joe to pass, and he's sacked back at the 27-yard line. Eric England came in from his end position to sack him.
That's England's first sack of the year, but what A&M did, and you can see it up here, is they overloaded, showed blitz. Everybody was coming. Atkinson up the middle. That freed England on the right side, and England got right to him. But had he not gotten there, Wheeler would have gotten there as well. This is a big play defense. You see the numbers there. 20 quarterback sacks. I mean, they've got big safeties, and they utilize them all the time.
We'll see if Jeff Ireland has his confidence back after last week. This one from 46 yards.
No.
And it's no good. Ireland misses. The trouble continues from the place kicker.
A company can learn a lot in 125 years. Valvoline has. You learn in the lab. You learn on the road. You learn on the racetrack. As you learn, you make your product better. And better and better. Today's Valvoline will keep your engine cleaner than ever before. And cleaner means more protection against engine wear. 125 years of quality. That's why people who know use Valvoline.
With which you're already quite familiar. Only now you can enjoy it at 35,000 feet. Delta's person-to-person service to over 270 cities worldwide. At Delta, we love to fly, and it shows.
Radio Shack, America's technology store.
The world listens to Radio Shack, and listen to music anywhere with this portable CD player at our lowest price ever. Or listen to the real-life drama of emergency, public service, aircraft, weather, marine bands, and more with this realistic scanner. And you can buy either on sale for only $119.95. Great selection. Superior service. Radio Shack. America's technology store since 1921. Nobody compares.
Well, if you come to Waco, Texas, you have to stop in on Jack and Jill Donuts. Why? Well, put a little chump change, maybe 75 cents in your pocket. Walk up to the counter and order some bear donuts. Yes, bear donuts in the shape of a bear's paw. Look at the size of those things. And a look at place kicker Jeff Ireland, who just missed a field goal. Now, he missed three field goals in the second half last week.
You have to feel for him. Look, he's the all-time field goal leader. He's got 42, but then look down the bottom. He's second place in the all-time missed field goal list. Matter of fact, two more misses, he'll take that lead. He had a 58-yarder before the half ended last week against Rice. Came back in the second half and missed three. I can't figure it out.
First and 10 from the 28 for Texas A&M. The toss to Hill and a fumble. He gets it back, though. May have lost 1 yard on that play.
Take another look. It's a pitch, and it's a low pitch, but it's not the quarterback's fault. As a matter of fact, Hill, you could see his helmet jerk up, started to look to see if there was a hole and where the pressure was coming from, and he took his eye off the ball.
Sets up second and 12. Ball in the 26. And off the Hill again. And he slipped again at the 29. Clifford Ellison made the tackle. Hill was busy 2 weeks ago. Gained 137 yards on 24 carries against Texas Tech.
Swinging gate play, trick play, here it comes.
And there's a flag
The official throws the flag.
How about that? A trick play, swinging gate. They had Richardson act like he was tying his shoe, get down by the football, and then pitch it.
They have a dead ball foul. False start.
They didn't stop. See, they got to come to a complete stop. And plus, you got to let the official know you're going to do something like that. Swinging gate, I love it. They're pulling out all stops. They did that against Texas Tech.
R.C. Slocum goes to his bag of tricks. 5:34 remaining. A&M leading 10-0.
Look at the quarterback, number 7, acting like he was tying his shoe, just picked the ball up like you're doing street football and got it back to Hill. They call that the swinging gate.
College football. 3rd and 14, two receivers out to the left. Richardson rolls out, throws, complete to Brian Mitchell. Good job of getting those feet down in bounds.
Oh, but the job was done by the quarterback, Bucky Richardson. He had all kinds of pressure, 17-yard gain, and he just kind of threw it on his heels because he was going to get hit. He knew he was going to get hit. Here comes Mitchell now. Mitchell takes the outcut, and he'll get his feet down. You only need 1 foot in. But the play was made by Richardson. Look, he knew he was going to take a hit. He's falling back, still whips that thing as hard as he can, almost sidearm, and makes the completion. Big-time play by Bucky Richardson.
1st and 10 for A&M. Play action, Richardson to pass again. Completes it again to the same man, Mitchell. The foot race ends at the 12-yard line. Michael McFarland finally dragged him down.
Another great play by number 7, Bucky Richardson. Got the ball out to Mitchell. All Mitchell had to do was catch it and run. But Richardson rolled right. He sees the cut by Mitchell, puts it right there by the sidelines, and then he's off. He's fast. That's his 7th catch of the year. He's got a 34-yard per catch average, so you know after he has the football, he's going to pick up some yards. But again, Richardson had a lot of pressure from Robin Jones.
1st and 10. Ball on the 11-yard line. Carter and Hill in the backfield. A hand off to Hill. A flag on the play as Hill burrows his way down to the 12.
This will be a penalty against the Aggies for holding.
McFarland and Maston made the tackle. Down by the 7-yard line. This one's against A&M.
Frustration by R.C. Slocum. Phenomenal statistic, though. Every time that Texas A&M gets down inside the 20, they score.
This replay first down.
So that'll make it 1st and 15. A little bit more than 15 because this year it's at the spot of the hole.
Ball's on to 18. Harrison out wide left. Richardson to pass. Throws complete down to the 11-yard line to Harrison.
You know, when the coaches talk about Bucky Richardson, they say, hey, this guy's big time. Don't just think of him as a college quarterback that runs the option. He's got a good, strong arm. Watch Harrison. Goes out to the sidelines and he'll drift back in because he sees Bucky Richardson looking to the middle. He drifts back in with his eyes and his shoulders and makes himself available.
2nd and 7. Harrison comes out wide to the right. The toss to Hill. And Hill goes down to the 1-yard line. Finding some room over the left side on the toss.
With 2 weeks to prepare, Texas A&M was idle last week. The Aggies are showing more tight end motion than I've seen them use for a long, long time. 86 short is in motion, and he comes and uses a kickout block. Hill cuts right up behind him and dives for the end zone down to the 1. So there is one of the new wrinkles that R.C. Slocum has put in for this game. More motion by the tight end as an extra blocker.
3 tight ends, 1st and goal. Richardson scores another touchdown.
The Baylor people are shocked.
Stunning silence here at Floyd Casey Stadium.
If this A&M team is this good with this many young players, imagine what they'll be next year. 26 freshmen or sophomores on the first and second team.
Vinatulius in for the extra point. Texas A&M leads 17 to nothing. Coming up at halftime, scores and highlights with Roger and Bo back in our studios in New York.
How about this? I don't think anybody would have anticipated Texas A&M coming into Baylor, 17-0 score. Here's the Aggie yell.
Come on, 12 man, put out.
Now these schools are separated by 90 miles, and the rivalry has some very deep roots. There was a time when Texas A&M did not take female students, and A&M men used to make the trip down the highway and, God forbid, date Baylor women.
Oh, my.
Ooh.
That'll get you going. Matter of fact, the Aggies bust in this morning just 4 hours before kickoff.
Vinatulius' kick goes down to the 5-yard line, down to the 2. Bell on the return. And he's tripped up at the 14. Kyle Maxfield, the backup defensive back, made the tackle.
All right, it is critical now, and I mean critical, for Baylor to get on the scoreboard. They were upset last week by Rice. They come into this game here with 3:46 left in the first half. They not scored, although they threatened. But they've got to get going. J.J. Joe throwing the football has been inept. They just have not gotten the offensive attack going.
Miles comes out wide. He's out to the left. The tight end in motion. Joe to pass. Complete for Miles. And Miles is stripped. Covers.
Last year when these two clubs played, Baylor suffered 5 turnovers against Texas A&M and had a kick block. Again, the turnover. He was stripped by Bates. And I mean to tell you, it's a big-time play, bringing his left arm down and picking him clean.
Lance Teichelman, the defensive end, recovered the football for the Aggies. And they are in great field position at the 45-yard line.
Baylor has not beaten Texas A&M in the last 5 years. The closest they came was last year, 20-20 tie. But they turned it over 5 times just like they did there, and that'll cost you every single time. You can't put the ball on the ground and expect to win.
That's a great job of running their football. That's why you run the ball. You fumbles that.
A lot of happy faces on the Texas A&M sideline. Look at R.C. Slocum speaking with one of the officials. There seems to be some difficulty. Coach Grant Taft complaining about some of the green gloves that the Baylor players are wearing. Pardon me, R.C. Slocum.
Well, I don't understand that. They certainly, one of the NCAA rules is all your accessories have to match your uniform. The gloves do. They're green. I don't see where the problem is.
Well, there's 3:38 to play in the first half, and A&M leads 17 to nothing.
Speaking of nothing and zeros, Cincinnati Bengals haven't won a game this year. They face the Buffalo Bills. 9 o'clock Eastern Time, Monday Night Football on ABC. It's first and 10, the ball at the 45. A handoff to the freshman Hill, and this time he's stuffed at the line of scrimmage by Robin Jones, a 6'4", 265-pound senior. They call him Big Cat Jones. Fullback, tight end in high school. Now they move him to defensive end. He'll be a number one draft pick. And here's the swinging gate again. And this time they're going to throw it back to Richardson. Mitchell throws it to Richardson, and he's got some space. Richardson down to the 9-yard line. The swinging gate opens up for a big game. Bringing out all the wrinkles, 38-yard gain. They tried the swing gate earlier. This time, instead of taking it all the way around, now you see to the right of the screen, that's a quarterback. Acted like he was tying a shoe, then came up and snapped the ball quickly. The ball goes back to Mitchell, who used to be a quarterback in high school. He throws back to Richardson on the right side's wide open. It's a trick play. It's been in college football for years. I think every team uses it. If you're on defense, you've got to have one guy assigned to watching the trick plays all the time, or you're going to get caught in a huddle. That should never happen, especially after they've tried it. Here it is again. Everybody's to the left side. Now the quarterback snaps it, just like street football. Somebody's got to come back and watch the quarterback. They don't. And then Bucky Richardson takes it all the way down the right sideline. Good thing there's good speed in that secondary. He had another touchdown.
Richardson runs a 4.6 40-yard dash. And I would think that right now, Coach Brent Taft would want to go to his local hardware store and buy one of those swinging gates.
Well, it's a play, like I said. Everybody at the end of every practice goes through a little session where you practice the swinging gate, the fumble rooski, what we used to call the Deacon Express, the Deacon Special. A lot of throwbacks and little trick plays that you use. And defensively, you've got to be alert for that. For instance, at Maryland, I was always the guy assigned. I had that assignment. During the huddles, I had to watch the opposing team to see if anything funny was happening. And when it does, you got to alert your team to it and yell, fire, fire, fire. And everybody comes out, and now you look for the trick plays.
Surprised that he's gone to it twice during the first half?
I'm surprised he's gone to it at all, because he's used it successfully in another game already this year. You can only normally get away with that maybe one time a year.
Well, the ball is on the 9-yard line. Two tight ends in for Texas A&M. Two receivers out to the left. Carter and Hill, the backs. They give us the Hill. And he's tripped up at the 9, falls forward to the 7-yard line. Well, today we have two of the best programs here in the Southwest Conference since 1985 in Texas A&M and Baylor.
Well, Texas A&M, obviously, with R.C. Slocum, 38-8-1 and three titles. Grant Taft's looking for that title over the last 5 years, but I'll tell you what, he's an outstanding coach. He's ready to get there. He was the coach of the year in the 1970s, national coach of the year.
Second and goal. The give to the fullback, Carter. Touchdown, Aggies.
There's the cotton for the Cotton Bowl, and their Cotton Bowl representatives here.
And also representatives from the John Hancock Bowl. Benetoulias, and again. And good again. Texas A&M stunning this crowd here at Floyd Casey to the tune of 24-0.
It's still very early, 2:21 remaining in the first half, so you have the whole second half to play, so we're not counting Baylor out. But I'm going to tell you this, if Baylor does lose today, they're out of the Southwest Conference hunt, and they can forget about the Cotton Bowl.
Well, you have to wonder how much effect that loss last week had against Rice.
Well, it looks like it's been big. Now, on the other hand, Texas A&M had last week off, and they now seem to be in the driver's seat for the Southwest Conference title if they win this ball game, because they play Texas, they play Arkansas, and they play Houston all down at Kyle Stadium in Texas A&M and College Station, and they don't lose many games there.
Well, most of you will see next week an SEC battle as the Bulldogs of Mississippi State meet the Auburn Tigers, plus regional action.
and a look at the remaining schedules. And there's ABC's college football lineup next week. Venatoulis' kick goes down to the 2-yard line where Kendrick Bell hauls it in. Bell is pushed out at the 24. Larry Jackson pushed him out of bounds after the 23-yard return. Important here now, Tim, you'd think anyway, for Baylor to get some kind of points on the board before halftime.
Well, we said that last drive, too, and they turned the football over after moving the all the way down to the 35.
Look at the scoring drive by Texas A&M as Baylor starts first and 10 on the 24. Joe hands it off to Mims. And he's tackled at the 22. Marcus Buckley made the tackle. Less than 2 minutes remaining now in the first half.
Second down.
There's a look at Richardson. He's had an outstanding first half. We said he had to be the stabilizer with this young attack, and he has done that. Boy, he has been sensational.
Joe now play action. Throws to the sidelines, to the 29-yard line. It's complete to Melvin Bonner.
Well, the Aggie people right there complaining that he was out of bounds. Watch this. See if he makes the catch inbounds. He has knee hit before his feet. I don't know. That's close. Oh, the side judge was right there and made the call immediately. It'll bring up third down now and long.
Joe from Arlington, Texas. His parents in attendance today. Made the trip.
Play clock is down to 10.
5 now on the clock.
They've got 2 timeouts left. They're going to have to call one here and take a penalty.
And that's what he does.
Smart play by J.J. Joe.
Is that an organization, Tim?
No, it was the fault of the coaching staff because they sent a play in with a messenger, but they didn't send him in until there were 18 seconds left on the play clock. So J.J. Joe was handcuffed. I mean, he had to wait for the play to come in. And then when he got up to the line of scrimmage, he was smart enough to look at the play clock and call timeout with 2 seconds.
Well, J.J. Joe is 8-2-1 as a starter in his career here at Baylor.
He's also very intelligent. He's a 3-6 student. He had that up to 3-9 at one point. He's recruited by Tulane and Vanderbilt. You know, Grant Taft wasn't even impressed with him as a high school player. Looked at him and didn't offer him a scholarship. It was offensive line coach Bill Lane that went back and offered him a scholarship and didn't even tell Grant Taft.
Coach Taft says he lets his assistants get away with that once in a while.
Well, when they find a J.J. Joe, that's good reason to let him get away with it.
Third and 12. Two receivers out wide to the left. Joe to pass. Eludes 3 tacklers and brought down by Marcus Buckley. All the way back at the 4-yard line. And look at all the white hankies in attendance. You'd think we were in College Station, Texas.
18-yard sack by Marcus Buckley, only returning starter at outside linebacker from last year.
Well, 1:19 to play in the first half. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Frank Gipper. Be with us this Monday night from Buffalo as the Buffalo Bills take on the Cincinnati Bengals. Quarterback Boomer Esiason will lead a frustrated Bengal attack as they look for their initial win of the season. Meanwhile, the Bills, sporting the best record in the AFC behind quarterback Jim Kelly, are thinking one thing, a return to the Super Bowl. See you Monday night from Buffalo. Monday Night Football.
Colombo, LAPD.
Dabney Coleman guest stars in an ABC movie special.
Ooh.
Colombo and the Murder of a Rock Star, Thursday.
Welcome back to Floyd Casey Stadium in Waco, Texas, on the campus of Baylor University. Mark Jones along with Tim Brandt. where Texas A&M leads Baylor 24-0 in a shocker so far. Fourth down and 29, and Texas A&M sets up for the block. Nobody back for the punt. They got it.
Oh, that was close.
Almost. This one lands at the 45 and bounces and stops at the 49-yard line. So with 1:10 to play, Texas A&M with great field position.
Watch how close this is. I really thought they had it. They overloaded, so somebody came free up the middle. Oh, you know what? He's got to take a better angle. See, he jumped straight up. He's got to take a better angle. That was Crooms, number six. If he lays out and crosses his arms, he's got the block.
Brentham got off a 46-yard punt.
Boy, that was big. I thought he had it. Had he laid out, he did have it.
The Aggies start on their own 49. 1:10 remaining. Richardson hands off to Hill. Play action, actually. Complete to Biggins. Bucky Richardson with a sleight of hand move.
Tell you what he does have. He's got a gun on that right arm. He really fired that ball and hit it between the two and the one. Could not have been thrown better. 18-yard pickup.
Richardson working the clock. 59 seconds remaining.
Biggins going to have a bruise on his chest tonight.
Richardson to pass again. Throws incomplete dangerously that time for the tight end, Greg Schroeder. And look at the discrepancy in total yards. Baylor's offense coming into the game averaging over 480 per outing. The incomplete pass stops the clock with 49 seconds to play in the first half. It's second and 10.
Boy, NC State unbeaten, just holding on against Marshall.
Richardson to pass. Looks for his wide receiver, complete to Biggins. Out of bounds, which will stop the clock at the 9-yard line. A 25-yard play. Richardson performing surgery on the secondary, Tim.
Could not have been thrown any better. 1 foot down is all you need. They got behind McFarland, the strong safety.
First down and goal on the 9. Richardson into the end zone, incomplete for Brian Mitchell. And that stops the clock with 32 seconds.
You know, you talk to the coaches and they were comparing him to Paul Hornung and Tom Matte. He's got a strong arm. R.C. Slocum told us that yesterday. He said, don't be deceived by our option attack. He says he makes great decisions, but he can also throw the football. He's an underrated player, and R.C. Slocum thinks he's going to make it in the pros.
Second down. Carter and Hill are the backs. They come out to block. Complete touchdown, but there's a flag on the play. Hill ran in for the touchdown, but there's a flag in the end zone. Flag down on the play. This one is against A&M.
I don't think either team could be happy with that.
Interference on the offense. 15-yard penalty. Loss of down. Third down.
See, now what's important about this is it is offensive interference against the offense, and that is a loss of down, and that is big. Watch Tony Harrison here, see? No, he's got the right to run. He's being cut off. Anyway, offensive pass interference was called. And the most important point about that is they have a loss of down now.
Harrison and Mitchell come out wide to the right. 28 seconds to play in the first half. Richardson looks to pass. Puts it up incomplete in the middle. Nobody in the area. And that stops the clock with 20 seconds remaining.
You know, it's interesting when you look at Bucky Richardson. Bob Toledo, the offensive coordinator, said that Bucky had his best three practices over this past week. Best three practices he's ever had. Said he's not 100% because he's got a sprained arch and a turf toe. But I'll tell you this, he is playing a great football game today.
Brian Payne comes in to hold for Venetulius.
It'll be a 41-yarder.
And he nails it. Terry Venetulius goes 2 for 2 on the day and puts Texas A&M up 27-0. A 41-yard field goal. And Tim Brandt, what does Coach Brent Taft tell his team at halftime?
Better tell them to wake up. There's an Aggie tradition that I like. After every score, they've got to kiss their date. I hope that's his date.
Talk about that one later.
A&M does have some tremendous traditions. That's a great institution. If you've ever been to College Station, it's special down there, as Waco is with Baylor.
Well, Venetulius came into the ball game 6 for 7. He's 7 for 8 now. 2 for 2 today, in stark contrast to Ireland of Baylor.
Yeah, Ireland's got a bad case of the Ophirs. He's 0 for his last 4. 3 possessions now for A&M. The last 3 possessions, they've had 3 touchdowns and a field goal. That's capitalization.
14 seconds remain in the first half. Miller and Bell are back deep. They squib it down to the 21. And John Henry, a backup running back, is brought down to the 32-yard line with 7 seconds to play in the first half. Look at the scoring drive last time. Used up 56 seconds and moved it 27 yards. And they almost blocked the punt before that in the end zone. Joe back to throw.
Wow.
Incomplete over the middle. It may have been tipped. It was an ugly looking pass intended for Bonner. Clock stops with 2 seconds.
See what happens now, you're trailing by 27 points. Your whole game plan is out the window. Everything you've practiced for the last week is gone. Now you've got to change. Now you've got to try to get some quick scores. Right now you just want to get into the locker room without letting Texas A&M have the ball back.
Second down for Baylor. Joe back again to pass. Looks over the middle, nobody in the neighborhood. And Patrick Bates almost had himself an interception to end the half. And a very vocal Texas A&M group of followers let their team know about their pleasure. They lead 27-0 after the first half.
ABC's College Football, brought to you by Chevy. The trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last. And by the United States Postal Service. We deliver for you.
Texas A&M
had only one drive that went past midfield. That resulted in Ireland's 46-yard missed field goal.
I mentioned the crowd of 50,267. The record is 51,200, set October 26, 74, in a game right here against Texas A&M.
Record crowds, love those record crowds. This place is jammed. But there are as many for Texas A&M as there are for Baylor.
Miller hauls it in at 3. Cuts it up inside, and he fumbles. There's a flag on the play. And we'll have to sort this one out to see who recovered. And Baylor was fortunate to recover the football. It really came out of there.
Here he is again. There's the hit. I think he was down before the fumble occurred. He had possession of the football when his knee and his body were down. It's going to be clipping against Baylor. I tell you, they've been working on the 12th man all day long. The 12th man is number 12, Robert Watson. Watch him. There it is, the push from behind. He's getting a good old-fashioned whooping today.
We have clipping on a receiving team on a return. Penalized half the distance to the goal.
That's all right. The clip was against Ray Matthews.
And Baylor will start on their own 8-yard line.
Remember, Baylor won the toss to start this game and elected to defer. That could have been the worst decision made today.
Tight end goes in motion. That's Pierce. The give to the fullback. He rumbles out to the 25-yard line. Robert Straight. And look at the offensive leaders in the first half. J.J. Joe only 45 yards passing. Straight, 39 yards running the ball. And Miles, their top receiver. Defensively for Texas A&M, Buckley and Neely very busy on the defensive line.
We'll talk a lot about Buckley in the second half. He's quite a story.
Two tight ends in for Baylor. The give goes to the fullback, and he fumbles as well. Mims tried to recover it, and now Texas A&M may have gotten it back.
They did.
Aggie ball.
And you know who made that play? Buckley.
Chris Crooms recovered the fumble for the Aggies.
Buckley is head up on the tight end. Now he comes across and gets right in the face of J.J. Joe. Joe looks at him, and when he does, he drops the football. Then it's just a scramble, and Buckley gets back there. Now his dad died August 5th, did Marcus Buckley. And he dedicated this season and his entire life to his dad. He went out against Texas Tech. He had three sacks, a fumble recovery, caused another fumble. And today, in this game right here, he leads tackles with four. He caused a fumble there and got it back.
And Mims is the injured player. He injured his shoulder last week in the game against Rice.
Here's a look at number 9, Marcus Buckley. He worked his way through high school, working in a service station, came into school as a Proposition 48. He hates everybody to even mention that because he's doing so well in school now. He's up and he's got his average well above 2.0, up near a 2.5, 2.8. He's on schedule to graduate. He's only a junior. Great story. Mims is up and coming off as well.
Well, the second half begins as the first half ended for Baylor.
Here's a look at Buckley. I was talking with John David Crow, the athletic director at halftime. He says that they were going to hype Buckley for the Heisman preseason, but then he got hurt. But I tell you, he is a great talent.
Richardson on first and 10. Movement up front and flags on the play.
Look at Buckley. He says, I want no parts of this. There's already been a whistle and a flag. I'm going straight down. I'm having no parts of Santana Dotson.
We have offside here. We got a false start here. They offset. Still first down.
Offsetting penalties. As we look at the Aggie offensive leaders, Richardson with an outstanding first half. And running the ball. Greg Hill, the freshman, with 74 yards as well.
Richardson set the tone for this entire game. And they're the defensive leaders for the Bears.
First and 10. Hill. Straight up the middle.
Back, carrying tacklers.
What a surge.
Oh, he's just a freshman, a redshirt freshman. In his first game, he went out and ran for 212 yards. He grew up next to Darren Lewis. He's going to be one of the all-time great A&M backs. He's certainly the fastest, but he just proved right there that he's also one of the strongest. Carried four tacklers all the way down inside the 5 to the 3-yard line. Two-time high school All-American sprinter. says he's never been caught from behind. And he says he never wants to be because his teammates will laugh at him. Says the only guys he thinks maybe could catch him from behind, maybe, Darryl Green.
Speed and then some, 84 yards rushing. Three tight ends in the ballgame. On first down, they go to Hill, the freshman, and he scores a touchdown.
GHT, Greg Hill time.
What time is it?
It is Greg Hill time. You know, he reminds me of Emmett Smith.
And this one is really starting to get away from Baylor.
Well, Wesley and Harrison just fired up and gave him a great big hole.
Next point is good. The Aggies score quickly in the second half. It's 34 to nothing.
To take your package to an address across town. And you could find somebody to take your package to any address cross country. Then you could call a third outfit that could take your package overseas. And yet another that could take your package overnight. But there's only one company you could call if you only wanted to make one call.
The world's first dynamo was invented by Werner Siemens in 1866. It began the revolution that brought electricity to everyone. That was then. This is now. The generation, distribution, and control of energy are at the heart of Siemens today, where you work, live, and play. And with 35,000 people at work nationwide, Siemens is leading the way into the next century. Siemens. Precision thinking.
They won their conference crown. This year, that's not enough. The Buffalo Bills battle Boomer Esiason and the Bengals on ABC's Monday Night Football.
Welcome back to Waco, Texas, everyone. Mark Jones along with Tim Brandt. Texas A&M with cotton on their minds. I refer to the Cotton Bowl. Maybe a little premature, but it is 34 to nothing, and a look at the new athletic complex here at the football stadium. Cost of $8.3 million, complete with a Bear Club lounge, a senior lounge, a weight room second to none. Benetoulis' kickoff goes to the 3-yard line where Kendrick Bell hauls it in. And Bell is stopped at the 18. Well, let's take a look at how we got to 34 to nothing. A&M opened up on their opening series scoring a field goal. Then Bucky Richardson in the second quarter ran one in for a touchdown, made it 10-0. Richardson again making it 17-0. And Doug Carter, the fullback from 8 yards out, continued the route. A field goal by Venetulius, a 2-yard run by Greg Hill, and it stands 34 love. 13:37 remaining in the third quarter. Give to the fullback, Robert Straight.
And there's Marcus Buckley again, came off that corner and made the stop. He's their designated blitzer. He comes off that corner. They play what they call a nine technique outside the nine hole. And he just comes straight down that line, puts pressure. Look at Maryland coming back, beating Wake Forest by a point. Carolina over Georgia Tech, that's a little bit of an upset.
And Michigan State winning. Second down and 7. Tight end goes in motion. That's Pierce. Joe throws. Complete to the 29-yard line for Lee Miles. Kevin Smith, the Thorpe Award nominee, making the tackle.
They may have to measure this one. It's awfully close. They'll bring the chains out, I'm sure.
Lee Miles is a track and field All-American. He has a sore knee. The coach is saying that Miles runs a 10.2 100 meters, world class.
Boy, that was close. They got it, though. First down. You know, earlier we told you Arkansas beat Texas today, 14-13, Texas with a missed field goal. And that game's big now because Texas drops a game in the Southwest Conference. Arkansas still undefeated. Texas A&M headed toward that direction. They could go 2-0 if this game holds up. Baylor now with its second loss, I think, has taken itself out of the Southwest Conference chase. I mean, they're out of the hunt for all intents and purposes.
First down and 10. Bonner in motion to the right. Joe tosses it on the option to Mims, who's forced out of bounds at the 32. Otis Neely pushed him out. Boy, Mims and Joe are going to have a lot to talk about tonight. The roommates.
Well, you know, it's interesting. Lashay Mastin, the outside linebacker for Baylor, he's having a Carter High School reunion tonight. So Brian Mitchell and Percy Singleton, Smith and Greg Hill, they're all going to spend the night over at his place.
I'd love to be a fly on the wall in that conversation.
But one of the rules, though, they can't talk about this game, they said.
Second down. Straight is stopped up at the line of scrimmage. Gang tackle. Quentin Corriott.
Watch number 44 in the middle of the pack. He's the guy that penetrates. He's coming right now, anticipates the snap, comes, overloads, shoots the gap, makes contact on Straight, and I mean to tell you, he put straight up. That'll put your eyes in your forehead and loosen your fillings. That's a great hit by Quentin Corriott.
Corriott, you know, his brother played football right here at Baylor.
Yeah, we talked about this in the first half. I can't think of any other school, maybe Penn State, that has as many great linebackers come out of it as Texas A&M.
Third and six for the Bears. Bonner in motion to the right. And flags down on the play.
Dead ball foul. Delay of the game.
Delay of game again against
still
Baylor.
Coming down.
You know, to continue that thought about the linebackers at Texas A&M, every starting A&M linebacker over the last 10 years has gotten a shot at the pros. What does that tell you?
They're churning them out.
That's also a great tribute to Bob Davie, the defensive coordinator.
Roper, Wallace, Holland, to mention a few.
William Thomas. There's Bob Davie, the defensive coordinator. What a job he's done.
Third down, 11 now for Baylor. Needing a first down. Oh. Joe Sack. About the 18-yard line.
Marcus Buckley again. Turn it loose, Marcus. Six-four, 225-pound heat seeker. Hunt and confront Marcus Buckley. Nine tackles, two sacks for 25 yards.
Living in the backfield this afternoon. Punting situation now for Baylor. Kevin Smith is back for the kick. He corrals it at the 45. Tries to get outside. And he's pushed out of bounds at the 47-yard line. A 36-yard punt. We'll be right back.
I've made up my mind. I'm going to do it. Why shouldn't I? I'm the one who has to look at myself in the mirror every morning. So before I lose another hair, I'm going to the doctor. I know doctors have treatment programs that are proven to work. More guys are trying them every day. I'm not bad now, but I wouldn't mind looking better.
Your doctor can really do something about hair loss. So see your doctor or call this toll-free number.
The savings are big during Sears National Hardware Sale. This Craftsman 3/8-inch variable speed drill is a great buy. Or for under $20, pick up any of these Craftsman tool sets or a new toolbox. Your choice, only $19.99. And this Craftsman 50-piece mechanics tool set is only $39.99. It's Sears' biggest hardware sale, and it's happening right now. And there's a whole lot more, so get to Sears National Hardware Sale today.
competition uses a very sophisticated, state-of-the-art, highly precise device to measure their cars. Our car, the Accord from Honda.
We've talked about some of the tradition here and the great linebackers at Texas A&M. They've had a good run of field goal kickers as well. Tony Franklin, playing from 75 to 78. Also played for the Patriots and the Eagles in the NFL. That was a 64-yard field goal against Baylor at that. And he followed that with a 65-yarder. Tony Franklin.
The Aggies, one of the Aggie plates. Yeah, they do win, and they win a lot.
First and 10, the ball at the 48-yard line. Hill and Carter in the backfield. Wide receivers are split. Richardson to pass. Throws incomplete, intended for Harrison. Let's go to New York and Roger Twible.
Well, thank you very much, Mark. An interesting story developing at the University of Houston. David Klingler is out this game with an ear infection, so head coach John Jenkins is not just alternating quarterbacks by quarters or by series, but what he's doing is alternating every play. Donald Douglas, Jimmy Klingler, and Chandler Evans. And they lead SMU 7-0 at the Astrodome. Figure that one out. They're 1-4 on the year. Mark?
That season has turned into a nightmare for Houston. The handoff goes to Hill. He's brought down just inside the midfield stripe by Hand. Brian Hill, the freshman. Pardon me, Greg Hill, the freshman, with a fantastic day so far. He predicted he would play well.
That's called efficiency. Only one punt.
Third down and 8. Richardson rolls out, looks back the other way, completes it to the tight end, Shorp. And Shorp is pushed out at the 42 and a bit by Santana Dotson. Another look at the possession chart.
7 possessions, and they've scored every time but one. And they would have scored that time, but if you remember, there was an offensive pass interference penalty. And so they've come up, and they've had 4 touchdowns, 2 field goals, and they've only had to punt one time.
We've got a holding penalty.
We have holding on the offense. Replay third down.
You know what else all those possessions have done? Not only put points on the board, but they've also, as we talked about, melted the clock. A&M has had the ball over 20 minutes to only 13.
Look at Bucky. Bears. Look at Bucky Richardson. The A&M staff feel that he can play quarterback in the NFL. Third and 13.
Randy Simmons. After seeing him today.
Randy Simmons in the backfield for the first time this afternoon. Hill goes in motion, and they throw it. They're looking deep off the pass. It's incomplete.
I got to tell you something. Brian Mitchell, he threw a good pass early in the ballgame back to Richardson, but that pass right there was bad. You know what? His teammates, we can laugh about it because of the score of the game, but his teammates are going to watch this in films, and they're going to get all over his case. Look, he's even laughing. He says, I know it was bad.
They will dog him out for that one. Fourth and 13, one of the few punts on the day now for Texas A&M. David Davis will kick it to Frankie Smith.
Davis is a walk-on from Luke, Texas. Luke, Texas has a population of 250 people, and he didn't even win the starting job there until his junior year.
Tough school. A high driving kick that lands at the 16-yard line. We have a flag on the play.
No, I don't think we do.
Looks like he got face mask.
I don't think so.
A 40-yard punt and 4 yards on the return.
If you have a house as messy as this and a son as helpful as this, get a shop vac. Look at the power this baby's got. A shop vac wet dry picks up everything from nails and wood chips to broken glass to gallons of water.
Thanks for the car, Dad.
Yep, there's no telling when you'll need the power of a shop vac.
Don't forget to get Steam Team, the attachment that turns any shop vac into a powerful carpet cleaner.
It was engineered to a higher standard with one of the world's most advanced suspension systems. It is nearly invisible to the wind. When it was built, it became an instant classic. The Accord Coupe from Honda. Everything else is just water under the bridge.
As we approach the 1992 Olympic Games, many are striving to be their best. They call him Iron Legs. But Richard Lowe isn't an athlete. He's a letter carrier on some of the cruelest hills in San Francisco. The 750,000 workers of the Postal Service are proud to sponsor the 1992 Olympic Games and share with you the quest to be the best.
We deliver for you.
Well, just across the road from our hotel, you can see the Waco Suspension Bridge, built in 1870. Exactly the first suspension bridge west of the Mississippi, the prototype for the Brooklyn Bridge. You know, for many years, it was the longest single-span bridge in the world. The bridge was certainly the first to be constructed across this state's longest river, the Brazos. First down and 10 for Baylor. The ball on the 20-yard line. Joe back to pass. Complete to Bonner. And Bonner is hauled down right at the 30-yard stripe. Derek Fraser, the cornerback, made the stop. Arkansas beats Texas. They missed a field goal, the Longhorns did. That's the 73rd and final meeting for those two teams. What a tradition that has been. Texas with a 54-18 edge, but they lose today. First and 10. Give to the fullback. A little or no gain that time.
Number 20, Robert Strait.
Robert Strait, the carrier. England making the tackle. Next week, Mississippi State against Auburn, plus other regional coverage on ABC, all beginning at 3:30 Eastern time, 2:30 Central. The game you'll see in this region is Mississippi State and Auburn. Well, Michigan won again today, 24-16 over Indiana. Desmond Howard, the Heisman Trophy candidate. Another big day for him. Texas A&M here has been some kind of hot. Second down and 10. Joe back to pass. Looking for Bonner. He was bumped and was impeded, but there's no flag on the play. He was bumped by Derek Fraser, good man-to-man coverage guy in the defensive secondary. And Patrick Bates was back there as well, free safety. Here it comes now. Once they get down to the 45-yard line, you see right there, he runs right into the back of Fraser. He wanted it, Bonner did, but you know, once that ball is in the air, the secondary, defensive secondary, has as much right to it as the offensive guy. You know, he came into this game ranked third in the nation in passing efficiency, completing 61%. It's third and 10. Joe to pass again, under pressure, the screen, incomplete for Mims.
Marcus Buckley's looking at himself right now saying, oh, I almost had it. J.J. Joe turned and looked to the left and threw the pass, and Marcus Buckley was coming. The ball went right through his hands.
Eric England was also in on that pressure. Another one in the long line of punts today for Baylor coming up. Biggins is back deep. Takes it into the 34 and brought down right away at the 36-yard line. A 36-yard punt. A tackle by David Lowe. 8:24 to play. Texas A&M having their way.
Aggies would be wise now to just keep the ball on the ground and run this thing and move that clock quickly.
Look at Cal.
How about that right there? The Buffaloes are rolling.
McAfee and Simmons now are in the backfield for Texas A&M. And a big hole over the right side, but there's some flags on the play. This is McAfee down to the 43 inside Baylor territory. Caldwell and Mastin made the tackle. But we'll wait for the flags.
We have offside on the defense. Penalty decline.
22-yard pickup by Keith McAfee. He had some preseason hamstring problems which slowed him down. He's got a 5-yard average every time he carries the football, and he's a senior.
McAfee out of Garland, Texas. First down and 10. Ball at the 43. Handoff goes to the fullback, Rose. He gets close to the 40-yard line.
They're just growing them down there in College Station now. Gross grew up just a few blocks from the campus of Texas A&M, decided to go there. He is another one of those freshmen, 5'11", 230 pounds, so they have more freshmen and sophomores. This is the youngest A&M team R.C. Slocum has ever had.
Second down and 7. Sharp goes in motion to the left. The toss is to McAfee. McAfee tries to square his shoulders, and he's hauled down to the 33. Nice game for McAfee.
Nice blocking by Gross, too. Number 31 led him all the way around the corner.
Look at Lachey Mastin, their leading tackler coming into the ballgame, limping. Relatively quiet this afternoon.
You know, you look at him and he doesn't look like a linebacker. He's actually a defensive back playing linebacker, but he is reckless. As the Bear used to say, he's agile, hostile, mobile, but right now he's a little bit dinged.
Tight end comes in motion to the right. The give is to the fullback, Gross. Let's go back to New York and Roger Twybell for some scores.
Thank you very much, Mark. Colorado at Oklahoma, and this run by Lamont Warren up the middle for 3 yards would cap a 14-play, 99-yard drive that consumed 6 minutes and 8 seconds. Their second 99-yard drive of the day, and Colorado looking for their 17th consecutive Big 8 victory. Let's go back to Mark.
Thanks, Roger. Oklahoma losing 2 straight now, or it might be losing last week to Texas. Richardson to pass, rolls out right. Fires complete to his wide receiver, Mitchell. Down at the 12-yard line. A 20-yard pickup.
Tackle made on the play by number 33, Michael McFarland.
They're just separating from defenders now. See the secondary's playing soft. Just turn him around, a little inside move. He's working on Ellison 4, and then Ellison slips again. Ellison got turned around twice on one play. Now, he's coming back from a sprained turf toe, but I don't think that's the reason that Ellison was tripping around on the AstroTurf.
First and 10, ball on the 13. McKeon goes in motion to the left. This is McAfee. Jumped over a tackler and was met at the 14-yard line by Lee Bruder.
Tackle on the play by number 61, Lee Bruder.
5:26 to play. And it's 34-0 Texas A&M over Baylor.
I'd say that's one of the few good signs we've seen this afternoon. Lee Bruder is back. He's had a hamstring problem, hasn't played in a while. Played behind James Francis as a freshman. He was a starter last year, though, and he's just coming back now and getting healthy.
No gain on that first down. It's second and 10. Handoff is to McAfee. Works his way up the middle to the 12. Santana Dotson, one of the few tackles that he's made this afternoon, conspicuous by his absence.
Watch number 77. He has been quiet, shakes off the block this time, makes the tackle. You know, Dotson's dad, Alphonsus, played for the Raiders. He lives now in Acapulco. Dotson almost went to the National Football League last year himself, but decided to stay in school, get his degree. He'll get that in December in communications.
Third down and 9. Richardson. He'll scramble. There's a flag on the play. Richardson scores.
Now they'll call it back, though. I think this is going to be holding against the Aggies.
They have holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay.
How about this?
Penalty was called on Tyler Harrison.
Well, he's playing with a broken hand today. I don't excuse him, but you see, he hits high, loses his block, falls backwards, does everything he can, then just grabs his leg. That wasn't much of a hold if it was a hold. You have to wonder how Texas A&M lost to Tulsa. You know, this club is only 1 point away from being unbeaten.
Third down, 23 yards to go. Goes all the way back. The 26. Richardson, pressure. Eludes a tackler. And is tripped up at the 28, and another flag goes down.
Boy, I'm telling you, Santana Dotson came through, got the pressure on him, and then old Richardson just ducked right under it. Bucky Richardson is having a terrific day. Now look at 77. That's Dotson. Here he comes. He better break down. He's got him by the back, and then Richardson says, whoops, turns and goes the other way. Boy, he's talented.
And very strong as well. Actually one of the strongest members on that A&M squad.
We have clipping on the offense. 15-yard penalty. Replay third down.
I thought it was interesting when John David Crow was saying they were going to push Richardson for the Heisman. They really believed that he's that good and that he should win the Heisman. But then he came out and he had that sprained arch. It wouldn't go away. He was injured the entire first half of this season and then got the turf toe.
Third down and an eternity. 38 yards. Out of the shotgun. Almost blindsided. Richardson gets it away. It's picked off by Walker. Walker tightropes his way down inside the 35. He stepped out of bounds. Actually, at the 40-yard line, they're marking it now. One of the few miscues this afternoon.
Frankie Smith gets his third interception of the year. Richardson could feel the pressure. Never really did push off that back foot because of the pressure. Just put it up for grabs, woefully underthrown. And Smith read it and brought it back in a hurry. Or Walker, rather, read it and brought it back in a hurry. Now, he played against Houston in place of Frankie Smith because Smith was hurt. So Walker stepped in and played against Houston, and he comes back in and gets the pick here.
So it's first and 10 on the Texas A&M 41-yard line for J.J. Joe. Bonner in motion to the left. He gives to the fullback, Robert Strait. He powers his way down to the 36. And Eric England hauls him down. Robert Strait has been one of Grant Taft's personal projects, trying to motivate the young man to play some football. Took him to Nebraska last year, gave him a little taste, came back and dedicated himself to his athletics.
5-yard penalty, replay first down.
They're going to replay first down and penalties against A&M. You know, the problem with Strait was he wanted to be a tailback. He was an outstanding tailback in high school. He wanted to stay a tailback, but Grant Taft wanted to move him to fullback, and he couldn't get motivated, didn't want to play it. So he took it, you're right, to Lincoln and watched him play Nebraska and never put him in the game. But he loved that crowd. Memorial Stadium doesn't get much better than that in Lincoln.
Tight end in motion. The give is to the fullback again. All the way down to the 25-yard line.
There's a guy who ran for over 8,000 yards in high school. To me, that's mind-boggling. Power guy, good feet, great balance. Can make a cut and then splatter people. Loves to play smash mouth football. If you look at the top rated teams in the country and how they did, Tennessee falling to Alabama today. That team just gets better and better, the Crimson Tide.
A toss to Mims. Mims chased down at the 20-yard line. Chris Brooms forced him out of bounds.
You think of the young teams that we've seen this year, We had Georgia early in the year. We knew that they were extremely young, and they get better every week. Alabama, we went to do them. We said, oh, man, this is a young football team. And they were sensational. And now we see Texas A&M and another strong football team, and all those clubs are going to be very, very good for the next few years.
McKenzie in motion. The tight end straight is stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Wheeler and England tag teaming. Set up third and five now for Baylor.
Quite an illustrious defensive front they have there. Of course, England and all the royal could they have. Patrick Henry and Sam Adams, all on the defensive line. A lot of history there.
History worth its weight in gold today. Third and five. 2:15 to play in the third quarter. Joe gives the straight. Down to the 15. But Quentin Corian stops him.
Now this one is
special. A&M defensive coordinator Bob Davies said yesterday that the Aggies had to be very, very physical today, and they have been that. They said that Bob, there he is, said he had to stop the run first, and then that the secondary couldn't overcommit. In other words, don't come up too quickly to stop the run and let somebody throw behind you. And they didn't do that. They've been very effective on pass defense, but up front they've been physical. Great game plan by Bob Davies.
The secondary waited, one of the best in the nation. Fourth down and one for Baylor.
You know what that means? Don't let them get a yard.
Two tight ends in the game. Straight. And he's got the first down.
Yeah, see, they didn't listen to Bob Davies. All that signal, that meant don't let him get this yard. And they got it. You'd think they'd be pitching for the shutout. Boy, good penetration by Wheeler. Did you see him shoot the gap and come in? He just guessed wrong, that's all.
Did you see Corriott go over the top? The ball is now into 13. First and 10. Give is to Henry this time, the up back. He fights his way down to the 10.
John Henry's a tiny fullback, but he surprised the coaches. He had a 64-yard touchdown run last week in the game against Rice. He's just a freshman, too. 5'9", 187 pounds.
Second down and seven. Pierce in motion, give up the middle to straight. Adams on the tackle. As time winds down in this third quarter. It's been all Texas A&M this afternoon.
Straight's a little bit hobbled. You know, we talked about the knee surgery he had earlier and he's had some ankle problems, but he's been effective thus far. It's been one of the few effective things that have happened for Baylor today.
And J.J. Joe walks up to the line of scrimmage and calls a timeout. We'll return with more action between Texas A&M and Baylor after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
A driver's side airbag is now standard on every new Accord, Civic, and Prelude. But remember, it's most effective when you wear your seatbelt.
Professional service, a friendly face. It's your Big A Pro.
Big A, the sign that keeps your car running right.
The energy to go further. We share that energy at Texaco, creating products like System 3 gasoline and Havoline Formula 3 motor oil. Performance that goes as far as it can and then goes even further.
With the highest resale value in its class and proven Honda reliability, the Accord is a safe place to put your money.
In just one day.
Woo! Good, good.
Dynasty rises again.
You're the most exciting man I've ever had.
Dynasty, the reunion tomorrow.
No! You got it!
three, pizza or cheeseburger?
Domino's, just what you want.
Nobody knows like Domino's.
Domino's Pizza's Bacon Cheeseburger Pizza Feast, a medium pizza piled high with ground beef, bacon, and topped with an extra layer of cheese.
Nobody knows like Domino's. How you like pizza at home?
Get a medium bacon cheeseburger pizza feast for $8.99. Get two for $12.99. Choose pan or original crust. Call Domino's Pizza now.
It is one thing to accelerate from a standing start, quite another at high speed. Infiniti designed the Q45 to do both. With a variable valve timing system so advanced, there is no compromise at any speed. Infiniti has, for the first time, blurred the lines between luxury and performance.
Chuck Norris stars tonight at 10:30 here on 13.
The students here at Baylor are just so eager and willing to learn.
You get a lot of personal attention in class, and that's what I think really makes the difference.
Most of your classes, you only have about 20, 25 students.
The professors go out of their way to get to know the students, even in large classes.
And the campus is very compact, so all your classes are close together.
The question is if you want to be one in 60,000 at a large college, or if you want to come to Baylor and be more than just a number.
A look at Sam, the Baylor Bear mascot, with his favorite libation, a little soda pop.
Good little early start on the celebration, didn't he? Hitting that bottle hard. Boy, this is the kind of defense now wants to keep that goose egg on the board. They're playing for pride down there, even though they have a 34-0 lead.
Joe rolls out to pass, and he's sacked. Oh. He throws it up, and it's intercepted.
Sam Adams picks it off. That's what you talk about, defensive pride. They didn't want to let him in the end zone. They got the pressure on him first. Joe throws it away, and Adams picks it off.
It might have been better to just to take the sack.
Well, Bonner was open. You see here, he comes clear in the end zone. Runs past the safety. But the problem was, J.J. Joe never had a chance. Now the pressure's coming right now. Bang, here it comes. Now he's got to unload it. He does. And here comes Adams. Old big Sam Adams comes and picks it off.
Soft hands.
Pressure came from Coriat. Interception from Adams. Boy, that is a great, great defensive stand there. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Baylor. Dead ball foul. They tag that on. Moves the A&M ball out across the 20.
Number 10, Jeff Granger, the new A&M quarterback.
Talking about Adams, his father played many seasons with the old Boston Patriots of the NFL.
So Dotson's dad played for the Raiders.
Jeff Granger is in the ballgame now, a quarterback for Texas A&M, the lefty. He almost fumbles the snap. Little or no gain on that play to Hill.
You know, Jeff Granger is a great story, too. He is a baseball player, pitched for the Aggie baseball team, set a record for strikeouts. He's an All-American, played for the Team USA. The Pan Am Games, drafted by the Twins, but decided to play football, so he came to A&M.
He's played in four games this season already. Second and 10. Granger on the toss to Hill. Well, Monday night, Jim Kelly and the Buffalo Bills take on the Cincinnati Bengals, the winless Cincinnati Bengals, at 9 o'clock Eastern time, right here on ABC. Bruce Smith of that Buffalo team hobbling a little bit, more than a little bit.
How about Kelly? He got knocked silly last week. Frank Wright came in, and they didn't miss a beat.
Third down and 9 now for Texas A&M. They lead 34-0. Granger rolls out left to pass. Looks deep, a flag on the play. And the pass is incomplete for Ryan Matthews. Now to New York and Roger Twyville.
Thank you very much, Mark. Washington at Cal, closing moments of the third quarter. Lindsey Chapman, the backup to Russell White, will get the block from Troy Ozine. Where's the safety? He went 68 yards for the touchdown. And they are tied at 17 as they start the fourth quarter in Berkeley. Let's go back to Mark.
Thanks, Roger. Wow, California. You know, interestingly enough, on my flight down here, I was sitting beside George Carlin, the comedian, and a very faithful college football fan.
We have holding on the offense, penalties decline, fourth down.
As I was saying, Carlin really follows college football quite a bit. His favorite squad, tied right now with Washington. Really likes the way Russell White runs the football.
Number 45, David.
David Davis into punt now. Frankie Smith is back for Baylor. Fourth and nine. Davis gets off a high kick. Lands at the 45. Smith gets up to the 50-yard line before he's sacked. Stay with us.
About style. It's about power. It's about control, the security of standard anti-lock brakes. It's about $12,000. The all-new Grand Am Sports Sedan. Excitement with purpose. Today we need to make every drop of oil count. So at BP, we're using advanced drilling techniques. Building oil fields that are smaller, more efficient, more productive than ever. Because that's the kind of thinking it takes to deliver about 10% of America's domestic oil. And to make the most of every drop. BP, the energy to change.
This is a commercial for this clever little portable CD player from Magnavox, the inventors of CD technology. I'm sorry, actually, this is a commercial for the ingenious Magnavox 13-inch TV with a built-in VCR. I'm sorry, this is really a commercial for this brilliant 50-inch TV with 100-watt Dolby surround sound. I'm sorry, wrong again, this is supposed to be a commercial for this Magnavox 386 notebook computer.
Hang on, we haven't finished!
Oh, I'm sorry.
The ingenious products from Magnavox. They're smart, very smart.
Michigan State battles Ohio State. UCLA invades Arizona State. Plus other key conference matchups next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
Baylor faces in the crowd today as we look at the largest margin of victory in the Texas A&M Baylor game, 53-0 back in 1912. The series began back in 1999. 34-0, 13-19 to play in the fourth quarter. Joe still in at quarterback, play action. And I'm not sure that he fooled Coria. In fact,
I'm sure. I'm sure he didn't.
That's good.
Coria doesn't take this fake at all. Watch this now, 44. Just comes on in, doesn't take the fake. And J.J. says, uh-oh, I'm in a whole lot of trouble now because here comes the support. And his support just took him down. But all you have to do is go to total yards, 394 of them, and time of possession. Almost 26 minutes, Texas A&M had the football.
Bonner in motion to the left. The toss by Joe to Greg White. Back up halfback. White, 5'7", 185-pound junior from Waco, Texas. Dragged down by Chris Cruz. Texas A&M fans on hand. Pearson motion to the right. Joe tosses it out to White, who hauls it in, shakes off one tackler, and is brought down by Coriot at the 50-yard line.
Crooms came on a safety blitz. Buckley took the swing man, who was the receiver, and then the pursuit came from Coryat. You know, this defense, which is playing so well today for Texas A&M, held Texas Tech to just 8 yards rushing for the entire game.
Boy.
Baylor calls timeout. 11:57 to play in a long afternoon of the Battle of the Brazos.
It took all day, but they finally came up with one very big idea. What do you bet they printed on a laser jet from Hewlett-Packard?
Since we became employee-owned, I think there's a far greater...
Joe to pass. Completes it to Mims, and he has the first down at the 48-yard line.
Oh, no. He gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Fire.
So the defense holds again. You know, this Baylor offense averages game today, they've got 129. Outstanding defensive performance.
Granger is the quarterback for Texas A&M. The lefty came in on their last series. He's played in four games, 18 for 40, 344 yards. Simmons does not want to go down. First and 10. Texas A&M on the 28. Simmons. Gain of 1 yard. McAfee that time. That Washington team, unprecedented speed for them this year in the lineup. They are quick sideline to sideline. Great speed at the running back position as well. Second down and 10. Simmons is the fullback. McAfee the tailback. The toss to McAfee. He's brought down at the 29.
Albert Fontenot came through, and I mean he put a hit on Granger way after the play was over. Granger, I think, is a little bit shaken up, but he is a competitor.
Maston was in on the tackle as well. Maston demanding that he's more than 193.
Watch this. I thought that Granger was going to lose his right shoulder the way he hit. I mean, that is a late hit. He was upended.
Third and 12. Granger rolls left to throw. Delivers incomplete, out of bounds.
Granger got hit again, and this time he's slow getting up as well.
Wiggins was the intended receiver that time.
Look at his shoulder. You can tell it's injured. He's just hanging his right arm. That's his non-throwing arm. He is a southpaw. But, I mean, he took a late hit the first time. And then after he released that last pass, he was sandwiched again and thrown rudely to the ground.
Played very well down in Cuba. He was a member of the United States baseball team.
You know, he drove all night one time to a track meet and finished third in the 400 meters. Didn't get any sleep.
Terry Venetoulias in now for a field goal. And they call a timeout. This one will be coming from 48 yards out. But it won't come until we come back. We're going to take a break. Still, 34-0.
Two people. Two airbags. The new Pontiac SSEI. A higher level of luxury and confidence.
every business morning while the rest of the world is getting up. UPS is guaranteeing overnight delivery before 10:30 for far less than other companies charge. And every business morning, more people are waking up to that fact.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Wow, he looked scarier 25 years ago.
Did I?
You looked scared.
I don't know. I thought I hit it well for an innocent groom.
You were innocent for the 60s.
Any regrets?
Yeah. You?
Just one.
What?
That I waited 25 years to give you this.
The 25th anniversary diamond, a brilliant celebration of the loving marriage.
I've got goosebumps.
Well, you've given me goosebumps for 25 years.
Well, time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental post-game report with Roger Twibel and Bo Schembechler featuring scores and highlights from a busy Saturday afternoon.
They've been working on Granger's shoulder the entire time out.
Vinatulli is now to kick from 48 yards out. Comes up about 2 yards short.
Looks like he hit it a little bit low.
After going 2 for 2 on the day, Natulius misses his first. It has been all Texas A&M. First down and 10, the ball on the 30. J.J. Joe still the quarterback. Takes the handoff and rolls. Downfield, incomplete for Reggie Miller, who got popped for good measure.
Took a pretty good leap from Kevin Smith. Kevin Smith, of course, the cornerback we've been talking about. Thorpe Award candidate. Caused 2 fumbles this year, recovered 2 more. 19 career interceptions. Best since Lester Hayes. Now started 30 consecutive games. He is tough and durable. I was just going to say that he was 5'4", 120 pounds in the 10th grade. Then did some serious growing. He's only 6 feet, 180 now. Big enough to play in the pros, though.
He was talking the talk before the game about shutting down Bonner, and, well, he's walked the walk this afternoon. Joe to pass. Throws, and it's broken up by Derek Frazier, the other cornerback.
You know, Kevin Smith has 3 interceptions against Baylor for his career. And if you look at the all-time interception leaders in the Southwest Conference, Kevin Smith is right up on top. Although Tracy Saw of Texas Tech is coming up on him closely. I think he has about 15 or 16 now. And Kevin's a little bit concerned because people are throwing away from him, but they're still throwing at Saw.
It's 3rd and 10. Smith has started 29 consecutive games for A&M. Joe back to pass again, under the heat and down again. Brought down at the 26-yard line by Pat Henry. Brentham comes in to punt now for the Bears. Wilbert Biggins is back. Biggins standing at his own 30-yard line. Nice high kick. Biggins fumbles it. And Baylor got it back. So the Bears get a late break. David Loeb recovers it. Backup fullback.
Boy, Biggins will hear about this from the defense. Defense is pitching a shutout today. They don't want to give Baylor good field position down here, deep in their own territory. Took his eye off of it, hit his chest plate, and bounced out. Baylor's got it in great field spot now. 28-yard line going in.
Well, if the Aggies have a kangaroo court, Biggins is going to face it tonight.
Well, right now, they better get their backs up. They want to keep this shutout.
A horrendous day so far for J.J. Joe.
6 of 18. They blitz. Joe picks it up, throws to the sidelines, complete to Reggie Miller.
You heard the crowd start cheering. That was the Texas A&M crowd. They're cheering for the shutout. Again, the pressure came. Joe had to throw it early and got out and let him early and long. But Miller made a nice catch running out of bounds. When he got to the sidelines, ran into one of his teammates who's not in uniform but on crutches. The crutches went flying, but it looks like he's going to be all right. I don't know who that is. He's got his right knee in a cast.
Second down and 6. Tight end in motion, right, to give to the fullback up the middle, Robert Strait.
Number 20, Robert Strait.
And Strait plows his way near the 20. So you see the building in the background. Coach Grant Taff has said that that building alone has helped him enormously in his recruiting efforts.
Oh, he's one of the great motivators of all time there in the yellow shirt. I want to talk about the time he ate a worm. We'll get back to that in a second.
Third and 1, and it's Strait. Brought down by Jason Atkinson.
That'll be close to a first down, too, depending on the mark.
Strait comes up limping again. Right now going to the sidelines. 8:04 remaining. Tim, at this point, if you're Coach Grant Taff, do you keep your starting quarterback, J.J. Joe, in a ballgame that's pretty much out of hand?
Well, I would, absolutely. You know, Taff's a competitor. I think anybody that's a competitor has been embarrassed today. They want to get on the scoreboard. It's going to be about a yard shy of the first. J.J. Joe, the very durable guy, he's the key to your entire attack. And Steve Needham's not the guy, so I would definitely stay with J.J. Joe. You know, we were talking about Grant Taff and what a motivator he is. He told the story about the two fishermen, and they sat out on the golf, and they sat out there in cold weather, used the same line, same fish, everything else, but only one guy was catching fish, the other one. He said, what's the secret? He said, you keep the worms warm.
And he took some worms out of his mouth. The point being, you got to do anything or whatever it takes.
Well, here's fish. Here's 4th and 1. They better do what it takes here.
Pearson motion. Joe gives it to the fullback, Strait, who Great. Keeps his balance and rumbles down to the 9-yard line.
Great second balance. Effort. Great call, great balance. You're not kidding. They came off the right side. Got a good push out of there by Jones and Bellamy. And one Strait broke one tackle. He knew if he could keep his balance, he not only had the first, but had a chance of breaking it. Took down inside the 10.
You know,
he's approaching the 100-yard mark. He's got 93 yards today.
First down and 10. Pearson motion. The reverse to the receiver. McKenzie. Touchdown, Baylor.
Number 88, Alonzo Pierce for the Baylor touchdown.
Watch Pierce go in motion. Pierce comes back around and takes the pitch. Trying to do is catch A&M over pursuing, and they did that. There was nobody there to contain, and Pierce took it in for the touchdown. That's a well-designed play. Grant Taff told us about it yesterday. We thought we'd see it early.
And now they go for 2 points on the conversion. Joe gave it to Henry that time. And he stopped far short of the end zone. But they break the donut on the scoreboard and get a touchdown. Next Saturday, Mississippi State taking on Auburn, a game you will see in this region of the country as well as other regional action on ABC. It all starts 3:30 Eastern Time, 2:30 Central.
Of course, we'll be heading out to Anderson, South Carolina, down to Clemson, where Clemson will take on NC State. NC State was unbeaten but was in a real close ball game with Marshall today. Clemson was idle. That game will be, for all intents and purposes, the championship of the ACC.
Boy, NC State taking a big gamble today. Barely coming out a winner. Taking on a Division 1A school, 2A school. You know, you talked about Grant Taft and that story about the worm. Didn't stop there, Tim. He went on after that in a big game against Texas sometime back in 1978 to get his team motivated. You know, for a big game, they were having a horrendous season, 2-8, 2-9. Needed a big win to change the thinking and help recruiting. Before this game against Texas, Taft put a worm in his mouth and told the guys, fellas, I'm willing to do anything. You got to keep the worms warm, and I'll do it for you this afternoon. And they went on to defeat Texas. And that game markedly took the program to another level, he says.
Two of the most congenial coaches you'll ever meet on the field today, R.C. Slocum. Fantastic coach, as witnessed today by his Aggies. Great person.
A&M setting up for the onside kick here. Got their hands team in. Squibler goes through the legs of one Aggie. Baylor saying they have it. The referee disagrees.
Texas A&M now has scored at least 34 points in its first four games. How about that?
Boy.
Here it is again. There's no question about it in the officials' mind, but Baylor players are still arguing. Took the high snap just like they want it. There's the ball. It's loose. The cover guys come down the outside lane for Baylor. And the official immediately signaled Aggie football. It's been an Aggie kind of day.
Now they have a new quarterback in, Kent Petty.
Well, you don't want to go back with Bucky Richardson, and Granger hurt his shoulder.
Kent Petty takes over at the 48. First and 10. Hand off to McAfee. Great lateral movement there. Across the 50 down to the 47-yard line, where Frankie Smith wraps him up.
Kent Petty is the 6'3", 203-pound junior, two-year letterman. He's out of Dallas, Texas, with the Lake Highlands High School. Strong-arm quarterback, came out of the spring as the number two guy behind Bucky Richardson. That's before Granger came in. Look at that.
The victors go the spoils. 6:30 to play. Petty hands it off to McAfee. McAfee stopped at the 48-yard line by Bruderer.
Petty's a former walk-on. Developed into a solid backup. He actually got into the Holiday Bowl. Saw action in four games as a freshman.
Now we have a Baylor player down on the field. Trying to find out who it is. Well, we'll take a break and come right back. Texas A&M leading 34-6.
A little brains, a little luck, and a lot of late nights. A good family, a good spot, and some good advice. That's the way it's supposed to be. And USF&G standing behind me. That's the way it's supposed to be. USF&G standing behind me.
The new supercharged Pontiac SSEI. Comfort without compromise. Performance without penalty. Excitement without apology. Pontiac SSEI.
Welcome back, everyone, to Waco, Texas. Texas A&M leading Baylor 34-6. The injured player that was down on the field just moments ago was Lachey Mastin, the linebacker for the Bears.
There's Mastin. They're working on him on the Baylor bench.
You know, Baylor's next opponent, TCU, is down to one quarterback. Tim Shade is the guy. Matt Vogler suffered a second and third degree burn on his left hand, non-throwing hand. Grease splattered on him. Went dove hunting, caught some doves, started cooking them, and had a grease burn.
Penny to pass. Incomplete for Biggins. That'll bring about a fourth down. David Davis into punt. Frankie Smith back deep. 6:12 remaining. Gets off a nice kick. This one will go deep into the end zone. Baylor taking over on the 20. 49-yard punt by Davis.
Boy, Davis isn't happy with himself either. You know, look at him. He's angry. See, that's not what he wanted to do. He wanted to pooch it, try to get it inside the 20. Tried to put it high, but he blasted it. Not the kind of punt he wanted.
Steve Needham now comes into the ball game, replacing quarterback J.J. Joe for Baylor. Needham is a 6-foot, 191-pound junior. Bell is in the backfield along with Henry. And a flag on the play.
We have a dead ball foul. False start on the offense. Still first down.
Can you believe all the penalties we've had today? Watch the left guard. Needham calls the count and they jump off. And Leaks, number 69, just came out of there. It happens so often every time you change quarterbacks because the rhythm changes, the tone changes, the voice, the sound, everything is different for the lineman. And Leaks is in for Turnfall. And so he came in. He was anxious. See that guy right there? That guy's waiting for him to score again. He wants another kiss.
Giving new meaning to the term illegal procedure. First and 15, a fumble. And Needham dives back on the ball. Now we want to know, can you or can't you if there's no scoring play involved?
Well, they're trying to decide right now. They're saying, wait a minute, do we need another score here? Do we need a field goal or touchdown?
.30 and counting. Fourth quarter. Needham rolls out to pass, and he hits Bonner. Bonner falls out of bounds at the 31-yard line. It stops the clock.
Needham is no stranger to playing football. You know, he proved his worth last year when he jumped in, filling in for the injured quarterback, Brad Giebel, and J.J. Joe. They were both hurt, so he is experienced. This time he rolled right, just let the receiver clear underneath Bonner.
Bonner with 4-2 speed. Need him to pass again, hits the same man. Steps out of bounds. You know, Grant Taff does not believe, interestingly enough, in timing his players in the 40-yard dash.
Well, there are some other coaches that believe that too, but you're right. It is interesting and a little bit unusual. But especially since he's a former track guy. You know, he was a head coach in college and track coach when he was 23 years old. But he says all he wants is quickness. He knows he's got them. Why time them? All he wants to do is make them faster than they already are.
Second and one. Needham keeps it himself. Gets out to midfield where he took a lick and a flag comes down now. Patrick Bates, the free safety, rocked his world.
Gonna tell you something about Needham. He's a former linebacker.
Have a dead ball, personal foul. The defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Here comes Needham, 27. Well, it wasn't too bad. But again, I'll tell you, Needham's a former linebacker that led Plano to its second straight Class 5A state title back in 1987. That's 12 penalties now against A&M for 124 yards.
First down, Baylor, the ball at the A&M 35. Needham fakes the handoff and passes. Bell caught it and was run out at the 35. Oklahoma struggling now, losing two games in a row.
Boy, LSU had to come from behind to get that 29 points.
Second down and 11. Needham on the toss. Bell chased out of bounds at the 27. Kendrick Bell getting some work now. Clock stops with 4:42 remaining.
Well, you think it's been a long day here. You think it's been a long day in the stands. How about those guys wearing those green jerseys? And they're going to hear about this for a long, long time.
Brent Taft pacing the sidelines still. Need him on the toss. And he's going to score. Bell. Touchdown. The official rules touchdown. A 31-yard scamper by Bell.
Got a block on the corner, showed some outstanding speed. Watch Bell now. The play was made by Needham, who brought the contain man to him, held the pitch as long as he could. Then Bell got into the secondary and broke that one tackle there. Outstanding speed, lunged forward to get the touchdown. Bell hadn't had that much playing time. Although Grant Taft said he was going to get in the ball game today. He's a freshman.
They go for two. Give it to Henry, and he doesn't get in the end zone.
I don't think Needham wanted to give it to him. He tried to pull it back out, and Henry wouldn't release it.
So the defense holds on the conversion attempt, and it stands 34-12. Really had a nice time visiting with Baylor head coach Brent Taft yesterday, as he showed us that facility you see in the background on your screen. Taft was walking around like a proud daddy, wasn't he?
Well, Baylor has spent $24 million over the last 5 years to improve facilities. What they want to do is be able to recruit competitively against the bigger schools. They want to be able to go up against Texas. They want to be able to go up against and get the quality players. And he was having trouble doing that when he didn't have the same type of facilities. So they improved them, as you can see right there, and they now have some outstanding facilities for the players. Grant Taft's done a great job. You know, that building doesn't have a name. They ought to name it the Grant Taft Athletic Facility. There's the second largest crowd in Baylor history, but boy, those folks, half of them are sitting home watching it on television now. They left early. This game was over early.
There was a look at the last scoring drive for the Bears. The second one of the day.
Baylor won the toss and deferred, so A&M took the football and elected just to run all over the Bears.
Well, coming up Monday night, the Bengals and the Bills from Orchard Park, New York. 9 o'clock Eastern time. Sam Weish and the Bengals still looking for their first win of the season. The onside kick now by Baylor.
Oh, they got it back.
And they recover it. At the A&M 45-yard line, Derek Frazier, the quarterback, got his hands on the ball and hauled it in.
All right, a little excitement now. Baylor's starting to put on some pressure. Not enough time to really be a threat, but at least they're putting some pressure on to get some confidence back. You want this ball to hit once, twice. Third time, you want the high hop. Here it comes. You want the outside man, the sprint man, the good hands man to come down. There it is. Perfectly executed.
Keith Caldwell.
Caldwell a little bit shaken up, but I'll tell you what. He made an outstanding play to get that ball. Oh, I agree. It has been a sleeper, but you better wake up now. Your Bears are going.
to that little girl. That's 34-12, 4.5 to play. The reverse to Bonner. Stepped out of bounds. Back close at the 45. They ran that little reverse toss to Bonner. Something they talked about doing earlier.
Just trying to capitalize on the over-pursuit of Texas A&M. So you send all your motion one way, and then you send Bonner the other way. But it's no doing. A&M was not fooled. They didn't over-pursue. They stayed at home and came up and made the big hit.
Second down and 9. Two receivers out to the right, one to the left. Need him to pass. Fires at the 33-yard line. It's ruled incomplete. Intended for David Wetzel.
Yeah, Wetzel was trying to sell him on the fact they did make the catch, but it was definitely trapped.
Well, we were hoping to bring you the Thrifty Car Rental postgame show back in New York, but due to time restrictions, we will not be able to.
This game has gone on and on and on.
4:19 to play. 3rd and 9. Glasgow, the tight end, goes in motion to the right. A toss to the halfback, Bell. Bell turns the corner and steps out at the 36. Bell showing some good speed.
Free safety, Bradbury was trying to come up and make the tackle, and he got outrun on the corner.
Boy, look at Miami, 49-0.
Washington over Cal now, 24-17. How about Alabama beating Tennessee?
Huskers rally against Kansas State.
Rutgers finally scored against Penn State.
4th and 1 now for Baylor. Two receivers out to the left. The give goes to the fullback, and he appears to have the first down. Bradford Lewis with his first carry of the afternoon.
I think he came up short. They won't even measure this one. He had to get to the line at least and had to cross that line. But he didn't get there.
Adams and Wheeler led the charge of tacklers. Well, it's going to be time for that man to get his charges regrouped. The Southwest Conference season that remains. 4:02 to play. Kent Petty at quarterback for the Aggies. Handoff is to Gross. Steve Strawn made the tackle that time for little or no gain.
See, it's important now for Texas A&M to get a first down. The clock is moving. They want to melt the clock and not even give the ball back to Baylor. They want this thing to end. And to do that, they've got to get a couple first downs.
Rice losing to TCU after defeating this Baylor squad last week. Whoops. Toss. McAfee finally recovers the ball back at the 13-yard line.
See, the quarterback's got to read the end. He's got to read the pressure. When he feels the pressure, he's got to release it. But what happened that time was the pressure hit him, and so he just pitched it. And there was nobody there. McAfee was already going around the corner.
Now Petty goes to the sidelines to have a little chat with head coach R.C. Slocum.
Well, when you look back over this game, you look at Texas A&M and you say, well, they came in as a young club with a lot of question marks. And we talked at the beginning about this being the really first significant test they've had all year, on the road against a contender. And boy, I want to tell you something. The youngest club R.C. Slocum has ever had passed with flying colors. Baylor, on the other hand, now having lost to Rice last week and being blitzed today 34-12, has to go back and have Grant Taft, the man right there in the yellow shirt, reevaluate what has happened to his ball club. He came into this season thinking national championship. Now he's just got to think, hey, how do we save the season? They've gone from national championship thoughts to, all right, now that's gone. Let's just win the Southwest Conference and go to the Cotton Bowl. All right, they lose today, now that's gone. Now he's got to think, let's just have a good year. Let's try to get to the John Hancock Bowl.
There are representatives from that bowl game here. Third down, 29. Handoff goes to the fullback up the middle, and he breaks a few tackles. Gross. Corralled out at the 37. Cliff Gross with some tough running. Clock is at 2:55 and ticking.
Well, a gain of 23 yards, so that'll bring up fourth down at about 8.
Davison to punt. Frankie Smith back deep. He's kicked the ball four times this afternoon for an average of 36.8 yards.
Clock continues to move. They'll let it move all the way down to the zero. They just want that clock to move, so that'll stop it now with the delay.
Dead ball foul. Delay of the game on the offense. Still fourth down.
So they'll back it up a few yards. Smith standing on his own 27. Miller getting good pressure on the punter. Gets the kick away. And it rolls and is down at the 30. 38-yard punt by Davis. Look at Bucky Richardson, the Texas A&M quarterback, really came out early in this ball game and set the tone, marching his team down the field in the first quarter. They got a field goal, and then two possessions later, in the second quarter, scored a touchdown as we look at the summation of the score.
How about the day he had, though? 9 for 15, 182 yards. He had 7 runs for 42 more yards and 2 touchdowns.
Needham now hands it off. Get out to the 29-yard line. Larry Jackson, the linebacker. Pardon me, Reggie Graham. Big win for Fresno State, 42-28. They remain unbeaten. Second and 10. Pass is complete down to the 35-yard line.
You know, it's a good sign, Mark. Here it is, time's going down, time's expiring. Under 2 minutes to play, minute and a half now, and Buckley is still in the ball game and still applying pressure. He hadn't let up a bit.
Projected as one of the next great linebackers in Texas A&M. You know, I was talking about Bucky Richardson. I'll explain to you how he got that nickname, Bucky, just after this play. Third and 4. Needham hands off to Bell. Bell is stopped at the 39-yard line.
Bell's a talent, isn't he? He's been impressive since he's been in there.
Now, with the win today, Texas A&M improves to 2-0 in conference play, 4-1 overall.
Okay, Arkansas beat Texas 14-13. It was a missed field goal by the Longhorns. So now Arkansas, which will eventually move on to the Southeast Conference, leads the Southwest Conference here unbeaten. Texas A&M in great shape because they play Arkansas, Houston, and Texas down in College Station. We'll be back.
Even a 4-time Super Bowl champion knows to reach your goal, it's important to get the nutrition of whole grain. These guys don't have it. Reedy's does. Made with 100% whole grain. So no matter what you're going for, better get your whole grain. Hey, Joe, you're gonna come back for one more bowl?
You better believe it.
I can't. No, I'm sorry. I don't think so.
Oh, no, please, no, baby, no.
Not now.
No, bad time.
Fight morning breath with Scope. Scope has two powerful ingredients that kill 90% of the bacteria that cause morning breath.
Your kiss is ready. Pucker up.
Right on the kisser.
Come on.
Kiss morning breath goodbye with Scope.
Give me that kiss.
Welcome back to Waco, Texas. The battle of the Brazos, no battle at all. Texas A&M leading easily 34-12 as they take over on downs. 42 seconds remaining in the ball game. Look at a happy R.C. Slocum.
Yeah, see that 42 seconds, that's celebrating time for these guys.